Cool. Right, so all I know about Dishonored is that it's steampunk and that it's stealth, and that Bethesda published it, apparently. I was worried that they developed it. You know, you hear that Bethesda made something I expected to be pretty buggy, but maybe Arcane Studios is more behind it. There's an ending at the end of the game. Spoilers, man. You gotta keep that stuff in exclamation point. Hide. Alright. Let's see. The boldest measures are the safest. Is downloadable content in this any good? I usually don't do DLC unless if it's really significant. And if it's too significant, sometimes I'll have it as a separate voting spreadsheet item. Notifications, player stance. That all sounds great. Not messing with controls. These fine details are fine. True subtitles are on. Just it helps with stream if I'm having to talk over dialogue, people trying to follow the story. We still see what folks are saying. I didn't know there was an option between killing people or being a cool dude. Normal, stealth in combat, moderately difficult, default enemy damage and potion effectiveness, casual experience for new players, health recovery is improved, potions are more effective, increased challenge for experienced players with increased damage. Normal is probably fine for our purposes. When I do stuff off stream, I try to go for the harder difficulties, but it tends to just make the stream take a bit longer, and we'll crank the gamma just because people watching have different monitor settings. Way everyone's at least guaranteed to see everything. See ya, sir. Catch you around. We are doing some Jackbox party games tonight. Andrea was looking forward to it, so that'll be at 5 o'clock Pacific, about 3 hours from now. Everyone's welcome to join. You don't need to have a... you don't need to pay for an application or anything. Play for free. Trusted to send so that you could remain near. Corvo.
But there is no one else. And the Spymaster was right to insist that I send you.
Might be doable in Sunblock? Okay, that's cool.
The plague has taken so many, and we must find a cure. When you are near, my heart is at peace.
I've definitely done a no-kill playthrough of all the Metal Gear Solid games. I don't think we'll do that when we stream it, but...
Hurry home, and bring good news.
It's fun. Renhaven River.
Steady hand. That's it. Watch it. Cast off line. Casting off. We're away.
Art style kind of reminds me of Bioshock. It's not trying to be photorealistic.
Take us straight to Dunwall Tower. Lord Corvo has news for the Empress, and we've come a long way.
Cool.
A long way to bring bad news. The sailors say there's a curse on us. Black magic.
Superstition. For all we know, there's a cure for the plague by now.
Maybe. We live in strange times. Sending the Empress's bodyguard away for a couple of months. That's unusual.
Hey, Marie.
This was important. We need help with the rat plague.
Yeah, I can hear that. It's very pretty. Oh, shoot. Triggering cat cam takes control away from the window. I might be able to drop the gamma a little bit. It's quite a bit brighter than most other games. I'll do that in a second. Once I get full control. Hey, the long wait is over. Right. Brightness. Let's just tone that down a hair. Usually turning it all the way up is a good deal, but it was pretty bright. Brighter than it needed to be.
It's been good traveling with you, Corvo.
Thanks. The game feels really slick so far. I mean, I'm just now walking around, but it's running smoothly. I like the art style. It's definitely a lot brighter than I was expecting. I really need to start recording a short 5-minute video of what I think a game is from what I've heard of it, versus what it actually ends up being. I expected this to be, like, super grimdark. I wasn't expecting there'd be any dialogue, you know? I don't have Neo. I think that, Chaos Factor's looking to add it to the voting spreadsheet. Hey, what's up?
Will you tell me about your trip, please? Were there any whales?
Hella whales.
Let's play hide and seek first. I'll cover my eyes and you hide.
Silent protagonist type.
Mother's busy talking to that nasty old spy master.
I watched my sister-in-law and her boyfriend play it. It was pretty cool. They played it in VR.
Okay, here we go.
Super Victorian.
Follow me, Corvo.
I need to explore the rest of the town. Oh, cool, there's a little distance marker. Game audio is a little quiet. Okay, hold on. Set it to the same thing everything else is at, and maybe the game is just a little quieter than most. You know if that helps.
While you were gone, Mother seemed very sad. I think she missed you. Leader, let's see if you're still good at this. I'll hide my eyes and count, and at the end of the countdown, I'll try and find you.
That's a clever way to do stealth.
I'm going to count to 10. Find a place to hide.
Press B to enter stealth mode, then stay behind cover to break line of sight with enemies and avoid detection while sneaking. Your footsteps are muffled.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Here I come.
I'm playing this on PC, but I think it's on 360. PS3, right? Holding Y and pressing left or right on the left stick, you can lean around corners, allowing you to look ahead without being seen by enemies. Oh, that's cool. So they can't see you when you're doing that. This is a really clever way to teach you stealth at the beginning of the game without being in danger. I assume I'm supposed to let her find me and not just hide from her indefinitely, right?
Okay, you win. We should go now, so Mother can see you too.
Nope, I'm just gonna stay hiding here forever. Surprise!
Did you see any monsters while traveling to the other isles?
Monsters? Okay. Heck yeah! Success. First try, too. I totally sight-read that stealth encounter.
Welcome home, Lord Protector. Stop moving, Campbell. And you, Corvo, welcome back. From wherever you've been.
They sent him all around the Isles to beg for aid.
A waste of time. My elixir will banish the plague from this.
This guy's a nice fellow.
Still a moment.
He's not going to be the bad guy.
I'm not so sure that painting looks like Campbell.
I hope he's not.
It was a fool's errand, Corvo. The plague comes from inside us. We must all strengthen our faith.
Yeah, I like the stylized approach. Took your cider. Ha! Climbing up your table.
Saw my improvements to the water line.
Sokolov. Aw, both kitties. I'll just leave the cat chem on true bit. Marty or Ben just showed up. Okay, I don't keep clicking out to activate it. I'm going this way.
She'll see you at once. Things are bad. Could the city get
Have you ever
worse?
Met my niece Callista?
Indeed, I believe so.
She's getting more beautiful every year.
Hello, my lord.
Hello?
They're sick people, not criminals. We've gone beyond that question, Your Majesty. They're
my citizens, and we will save them from the plague if we can. All of them.
Very well.
We will not speak of this again.
Mother, Corvo is back.
Thank you, Emily. Leave us, please.
As you wish, Your Majesty.
I'm excited. I have no idea where this is going from a narrative perspective. They've given us a lot of plants, like plague, monsters.
As usual.
It's a fair wind that brings you home to me.
Follow me,
what
Captain.
News have you brought?
Yep.
I hope that one of the other cities had dealt with this before, knew of some cure. This news is very bad.
So you're sprinting and slide? That's pretty cool. And slide into cover, presumably?
They're going to blockade us. They'll wait to see if the plague turns the city into a graveyard.
Are you okay, Mother? You seem sad.
Yes, don't worry, darling.
Pretty.
Mother is fine. Wait, where are the guards? Who sent them away?
Mother, uh-oh. Look! What are they doing on the rooftop?
What? Emily, come here!
Oh no. Ninjas? Just right trigger to attack with your right hand or left trigger to attack with your left hand if you have a weapon or power equipped. I know there's sword play in this. Press and hold right bumper to block incoming sword attacks. Perfect timing will put the enemies off balance and open them up to a lethal counterattack. Feels pretty good. Although first person melee never really works, I feel like.
Men, Mother?
I don't know, Emily.
Jerks.
Corvo, thank you.
Skirts would have taken too much processing power. Oh, I love when stuff like that happens. Technical limitations inform things like character and level design. Like how Mario wears Oh jeez, that sucks. Holy shit. Whoa. Alright, shit is real, real quick. Oh, it's a bummer.
Corvo, it's all coming apart. Find Emily. Protect her.
Mario wears overalls so they could distinguish his arms from his legs.
You'll know what to do. Won't you?
And he was Jumpman in Donkey Kong. Dude. It wasn't me who did that, it was ninjas.
Look at what he's done.
No, come on, guys.
He's killed the Empress.
No. Didn't you see the ninjas?
Young lady Emily, traitor.
Victorian ninjas?
Bodyguard. Ironic. I'll see you beheaded for this, Corvo. Peg him.
So I got dishonored. Cool. Yeah, and this suddenly becomes... Surprise, it's not really a stealth game, it's a lawyer game. Bum 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 bum.
This is your final chance, Corvo. Sign the confession and let me give you the rights to put your spirit at ease.
How can you not brand me? The Dishonor brand?
For now, get out. Let's give the man some time to think.
Cool painting in the background. Yeah.
Corvo, the Empress is dead.
It's one of those things where it becomes really hard to sell that sort of thing. Like, you can't tell anyone what, Tucker and Dale vs. Evil, or Cabin in the Woods, or Edge of Tomorrow are actually about. Because the surprise genre shift is what makes it so fun.
There was nothing personal in this, even though you almost sank our plans. But it turned out well. You were in the wrong place at the right time, and someone has to take the fall.
It's the sort of fiction that, like, you have to rely on word of mouth and people, like, trusting other people. for them to get the full experience. Or you get situations like, you know, Terminator 2, where the movie's main plot twist was spoiled by the trailers for everyone.
You should eat, Corvo. This meal comes from a friend.
Yeah, I'm just saying, if you want to get other people to play it, it's a lot harder when you can't tell them, like, what the big draw is, you know? A little fire that warms is better than a big fire that burns. I agree with that. How quickly are we going to get out of prison? Countdown. I should add that as a counter. Broken out of jail X times. I'll start with innocence, for the world leads us to guilt. Cake is a lie, etc., etc. Oh, what do you know? There's a way out of the prison in the bread.
Oh my god. Oh my god! Although actually it was sort of obvious.
Here's the key to your cell. Once you're out, head for the prison's interrogation room. Take the explosive there and plant it on the outer door. When the bomb goes off, run, make for the river and lose yourself in the sewers. Find some useful gear stashed there. One of the prison guards will leave a weapon just outside your cell. Good luck, we need you alive for what's to come. Rad. I like the idea of stealth with the sword. It's cool.
So many people are coming to the execution.
Assassinations and non-lethal takedowns. With the sword in hand, assassin, unaware enemy, pressing right trigger, approach an unaware enemy from behind, and hold the right bumper to perform a non-lethal takedown. Fewer rats and weepers. Rats? Huh. Final outcome is not as dark. Thanks, game. A little on-the-nose way to describe it. I have to hold the button? Well, can I load? Assume that just takes me right back in here. Apparently you have to hold the button down for that to work. Lesson learned. Take that money? Oh, I can. Yeah, it's very, it reminds me a lot of Bioshock Infinite, just in the way you play.
So many people are coming to the execution tomorrow.
Like guards talking to each other?
The one who killed the Empress and abducted her daughter, Emily. So it's an occasion. Right.
Yeah, I'll try to figure that stuff.
Come see the noble Lord Protector get his head chopped off.
Bad as us betting on the dogfight.
Attention, the solitary is off limits to maintenance crews unless accompanied by an officer of the watch. Escort through the solitary wing must be scheduled in advance with 1 week's notice.
So seepy. It's so convenient that we can knock people out without causing permanent brain damage. Such an interesting, like, utility of fiction. Right? It's not how the real world works. How easily can I save in this? Alright, somewhat easily. No. I mean, you're talking about me pressing right bumper to non-lethal because I tried the non-lethal. Is there another button I could press while I was doing non-lethal to change my mind?
Attention. Tomorrow's execution will be restricted to the personnel.
It's what the message said earlier, so I pressed right bumper to knock him out. Yeah, that's... yep. But you're saying while I'm pressing right bumper, I can press another button to kill them? Yeah, right, Yukipo.
It's just ridiculous. Stupid rats. Plague. Elixir. Bunch of crap.
Yeah, that's okay. That's what the pop-up said. It was like, if you press right trigger, you kill them with your sword. If you press right bumper, you choke them. Yeah, I caught that. Thank you, though.
Attention. The solitary wing is off limits to maintenance crews.
I didn't skip it.
Accompanied by an officer of the watch.
I made a mistake when I was trying to grab the first guy. I didn't realize I had to hold the button down and I had to load my save, so when I went back into it the second time, I skipped it. You can hold X immediately after knocking down to let them fall, I see. Nah. Thank you, though. Whale oil tax. Whale oil. Sokolov's health elixir. I'll be to open the pickaxe wheel and press B to drink a potion. I see. Now I got a pistol that I probably won't use unless I absolutely have to. Hey, Plaster, what's grooving? Do knocked out dudes wake up eventually, or are they effectively out permanently? I really like the diving for cover, that's cool. Chomping down stuff. The Hound Pits. Scudder versus Blackie. Wager on the most vicious hounds in the city as they run with another by Jaw and Fang. Come to the pub known for the best ales and the freshest blood ox stew. Sounds delightful. Is there like an inventory limit in this game? Like an encumbrance system? I'm fine on health. Oh wait, there is like a look through keyhole option. I can pick pockets, that's interesting. So if you don't pick their pocket, you can't get their loot. You get something extra if you pick their pocket, I guess. Inventory limits per item kind. Okay, that's good to know. I had another question, but I lost it. If I remember, I'll ask. They don't wake up of their own accord. Okay. Oh, once you've knocked somebody out, can you accidentally kill them by like dropping them off a ledge or something? Notice you can throw their bodies. Unbreakable door. Roger. That's progress. Let's try going this way.
Attention. Tomorrow's execution will be restricted to the personnel assigned to the event and approved dignitaries only.
Can you kill the rats without any penalty? Like the keyhole thing, that's neat. Kill all the rats. The rats are like evil in this, though, is what I'm perceiving. They're like carriers of plague, presumably. This is like a shortcut that I just opened. Okay, because I've already been here. Hey, look! Conveyance tape! Very nice. Plague schmag. Yeah, so you can distract guards, I assume. Hello. What was the button to pickpocket? Is it hold X behind them? It might give me the prompt next time if I pay attention. I'm sorry if someone already answered this, but if you do you get extra items if you pickpocket them before you knock them out, or do you always get all the loot that they're carrying when you knock them out? Hold X, okay. I'm seeing the guards down here. My assault on radar. More rats. Sorry, rats. It's a you or me type situation. I feel bad. Yeah, I agree, but I've definitely played games that have done stuff like that, you know? Thought I saw some shiny loot over here. Maybe it was just a reflection of the water on the ground. No? Okay, cool. Drink from the sink. Wash my face. Yeah, every JRPG with a steel mechanic ever. I see. Cool painting. Duty officers report. Corvo's interrogation. Corvo Atano, formerly the Royal Protector, brought in for interrogation. This is of utmost importance. Lord Regent and High Overseer Campbell will conduct the questioning themselves. Yeah, when they were calling me Lord Protector earlier, I was confused. I assume that that's a much higher title than, like, you know, bodyguard. Follow their orders without hesitation and keep the torturer under control. If Corvo dies in his hands, instead of getting the public execution Lord Regent wants, it'll be your head that rolls next.
Okay.
They're trying to frame me. Oh, that's cool. Wow. Only works in Whisper, Johan. Or Discord DM. Otherwise, it would double up the message every time. Yeah, so, like, the audio logs, the way the thing is, the whole game is laid out, picking up money, eating chips and stuff. This feels like, you know, it's cool. It's like when, Dark Souls came out and people started making Dark Souls-like games. Has the developer talked about being inspired by the first Bioshock? Oh. Okay. That's clever. I don't have any need to do that right now, but I'll keep that in mind. Trials of Aptitude. Once a child shows the proper inclination, he's marked. Overseers are assigned to study the subject surreptitiously in order to determine whether this inclination is supported by cosmological conditions and other signs ongoing throughout the year. At the end of the cycle, those befitting further testing are removed from their homes some hours before dawn and must begin the march to an outpost outside the city. There, the children undergo ritual preparation and evaluation until the last night of the month of rain. They make a pilgrimage to Whitecliff. All these proper nouns. So cool. Know a little bit about Deus Ex and Thief. I can see both of those. Watched a friend play a bit of the first Deus Ex. Clockwork explosive. Neat. Whale oil. You have a garden here now? I'll bring one of these things just in case. Yeah, it's a clockwork explosive, not a regular explosive.
Attention. Tomorrow's execution will be restricted to the personnel assigned to the event and approved dignitaries only.
Beckworth, Clancy Slaughter. Did you patrol the yard?
Sorry. Not yet. I was gonna report that boiler leak from yesterday.
Forget it. Just do your rounds. The report's trouble for both of us.
I'm moving.
Stupid goddamn Dublin somehow.
Heard something.
Wasn't me.
Attention. The solitary wing is all.
I like that use of. It's not a traditional radar, right?
An officer of the watch. Escort to the solitary wing must be scheduled in advance with 1 week's notice.
They didn't come and investigate that the way I was expecting them to. Let me try that again. Try that again.
What you'll do if Slackjawed as Bottle Street Boys jump you?
Shut up.
Attention. Tomorrow's execution will be restricted to the personnel assigned to the event and approved dignitaries only.
Shit, he heard me, didn't he? Come on. Guards have some humanly limited senses. Perfect. Does that actually get harder on the higher difficulties, or is it mostly things like damage? Hey, thanks for the follow, Kai Mom. How are you? Just my imagination would be a good one. Woo!
Okiska?
Kai Mom is Kai Han's mom, appropriately named. We already finished Monkey Island, but you can always check out the VOD on YouTube. My kingdom for a quick save key. I don't know whether I'm gonna do a lot of save scouting, but.
Attention.
Those door noises that keep playing keep freaking me out. Awesome, Jahan. Keen pleasure. Need to do more of. Speaking of keen pleasure. Hello. Are these the dumb kind of guards that can't look out windows? Now, whenever I'm holding Y to peek out of an edge, I'm not technically in line of sight, right? It's like a superpower that I have. Presumably. Have you tried not being sick with the plague? Peeking is safe, windows are not. Okay. Good to know. Now, is there any reason to eat food when I'm at full health? Probably not, right? Unless accompanied by an officer. Oh, hello. Escort through the solitary wing must be scheduled in advance with 1 week's notice. There's loot, more health elixirs. What else we got? Brined hagfish. That sounds jellied eels. Tasty. Alright, that all went really well. I'm gonna jump on this conveyance thing here in a second. Oh, is it considered dickish to steal food in this game? I used to go around Bioshock eating all the potato chips. It has a little red icon if it's gonna get you in trouble. Yeah, right? Although the game might not be fun if they were too smart. I'd be really interested to see someone try to make a, like... Oh, cool. Yay, conveyance tape. Someone try to make a stealth game with really, really smart guards that manages to stay fun, you know? It's kind of an advantage you need as a player, I think. It's pretty cool. This game kind of gives me the combat's nothing like it, but the Arkham Asylum feel that, like, if I got into a fight, I'd be okay. But being stealthy is more stylish, you know? I'm worried about dropping down here. Drop an enemy from above and press right trigger reach for landing and perform a drop assassination. You won't take any damage from the fall. Well, what if I don't want to kill him? Can you do a drop? I like how there's a light auto-aim. It makes it pretty clear when you're doing it. Can you do a drop knockout, or is it only drop assassinations? No drop choke. How loud would this drop be? Do you think this is loud enough that it would be guaranteed to tip them off? I'm trying to see if there's somewhere else I could more safely reach. I can try that real quick. I don't know if I can get back up there though. See what my level of jump skill is. Alright, not bad. Better than expected. One way to find out. Save, and then attempt. Oh, you don't make any sound when crouched? Okay, so you can drop silently. Which is probably the way to go, so I don't have to deal with the other guy. I like that this game takes a pretty simple FPS mechanic like crouching and like gives you super crouch. I'll save once he walks over here and we'll give it a try. He patrols down in the center, which isn't where we want to deal with him. We want to drop over here. Once he walks there, that would be my chance. Wrong place, dude. This way. Woot. That was cool. Timing of that sound effect actually worked out pretty well. Cool. Alright, let me try to, in case new guards show up later, let me try to hide them. He's got loot, bullets, health elixir, hayfish. What else we got going on in here? Anything interesting? Oh, can I hide in trash bins? That's cool. I think that's all that's down here. I'm just making sure I'm not missing anything. Okay. Let me pull the switch. Let me just plant this bomb. Oh yeah, let me get the hell out of Dodge. It's the stealthiest thing I could have done. Ow, dicks. Hey, I can swim in this game, that's cool. I think they saw me. They're very quiet, very careful. Take caution. Sets off explosive. Follow me through a zone border, guards. This game's really cool so far, I like it. More rats. That's a lot of rats, holy shit. Wow, that's scary. Note from a friend. Greediness, it means our plan worked and you've broken free from Coldridge. One of our contacts has hidden weapons for you somewhere deeper in the sewers. Grab the gear and find Samuel. These tunnels dump out on the river. We'll bring you to us, a friend who will meet you soon. Sweet. How does that work? What kind of game is Ghost Recon? I've never played any of those. Cannot be open at this time. Don't see any conveyance tape game. I guess there's a red light up here. Looks like red is conveyance in this game. Whoa! Holy shit. Alright. Okay, I feel less bad about killing those rats earlier. Oh my god. It's kind of over the top. What a cool way to establish... Hey, if you see a big horde of rats like that, they're not just kind of gross. Maybe you should stay away from them. They don't always look for conveyance tape, it's fair enough. Although there was still conveyance color there for the red light. Yeah, let's maybe not go in that room. Let's maybe not. Oh, that's nice. If you're doing a kill building. You cannot kill the rat plague. Rats are eating our babies. Oh jeez. There's a Rat King boss in this game. There's gotta be, right? Yeah, where are the fancy rats? I feel like this is a universe where, like, you do not want to be in a sewer, right? This is, like, the worst place. At least I can sneak from the rats, right? Presumably. That didn't go quite as well as I wanted it to. Oh, Dude, screw this noise. They not follow me into the water? Okay, good to know. Ew, covered in sewer water. Ew, rats! It's a rat dodging puzzle. Yes, yes. That didn't go the way I expected it to. Thought that was a ladder I could climb, I guess not. Oh, I have to go down here? Ew, gross. Ew, poop water. Gnarly. Alright, well, I was averse to getting in the water, but apparently it's not a big deal. That's sad. Damien's journal. Smell-o-vision finally invented. Yeah. Sewers are such a common trope in video games too, right? Like, every game has a sewer level. Amanda and I only had enough coin to buy half the elixir we needed. Even that's all gone now, and there's nothing to do but wait. And I wonder what it is, it's not even just video games, like, exploring sewers is a hallmark of tabletop RPGs back into the 70s. I feel like you don't really see it in fantasy movies as much as it is in, you know, fantasy gaming. I don't know, maybe it's because they're labyrinthine, so it's like a dungeon, natural dungeon. Even that's all gone now, and there's nothing to do but wait. We're very sick, and there's no place above to hide from the city watch. They're breaking into houses all over our district, so we'll stay here and share the last hours together. Our fire will keep the rats away, but they'll inherit this city. Rats potentially don't like fire. Good to know. Well, I don't have much fire left. Yeah, I'm gonna die of the Ultra Plague. Yeah, right? It's kind of mysterious because there's a sewer under every town and you wonder, like, man, what's actually down there? Sure, a plumber would tell you it's not that exciting. Sewer worker. Alright, so when I see the little gear icon in the bottom right corner, that's an autosave, is that correct? A corpse is blocking the wheel. Sorry, bud. Go kill 20 tavern rats, all that fun stuff. I think games have gotten better about that. It's one of those early rules to a newbie GM if you're doing a game like Dungeons & Dragons. Like, whatever your cool idea is, if you want the party to have an awesome face-off with a dragon or a vampire or something, have that be the first adventure. Don't start with them, like, hunting tavern rats. You're never going to get to the cool dragon if that's what you start with all the time. And it's kind of a problem because you're starting to see games always have to have a crazy exciting opening. Like, it's getting a lot rarer that AAA action titles will have an hour of quiet, ambient, like, suspense-filled opening. There's always got to be something crazy happening right at the beginning. Hey, Dangle, how's it going?
That's too far. I don't want to catch the plague, do you? No. Doesn't the elixir prevent it? Maybe. Either way, let's just dump them down there.
Oh. I see. Sewer mail. Ha. Mostly stay in contact through Discord, but I do post, like, my go live notifications and stuff on Twitter. Everything is at Marstead. Facebook, Twitter, Discord, all that fun stuff. Yeah, I agree. I mean, there's the assassination happens fairly early, but being able to do a little boat ride and playing hide and seek, little girl, it's pretty cool and unusual, I feel like. So unlike real rats, these rats can't climb, presumably. So the floor is lava, except the floor is rats. Come on. Stupid rat AI. Realizing that I'm luring them.
Attention, Dunwall citizens.
the assassin Corvo, responsible for the murder of our fair Empress and the disappearance of Lady Emily, heir to the throne, has temporarily escaped state custody. Any evidence as to his whereabouts must be delivered to the city watch at once.
Climb change or jumping onto them or pressing X one year. Okay. Can do. The outsider walks among us. Rat skewer. Delicious. Maybe that's the kind of thing we don't want to eat. I'm sure there's two different alignments in this game. There's good, you didn't kill a lot of people. Evil, you killed a ton of people. And then there's like, how plague are you? How sick are you? Okay, climbing chains is kind of wonky from what I expect, but I think we'll get used to it. Copper wire. Oh, it's just worth money. That's interesting. Well, it's not eating the rotten stuff. How plague are you? Tripwire. Whoa! Okay, well, I guess triggering it on purpose is not the way to go. Unless if there's a way for you to dodge it or block it or something. Well, now I know. Launcher disarmed. Hooray! Thought maybe trigger meant disarm, you know, since I saw it and interacted with it, but no. So Dishonored 2's already out, right? It came out like last year. What's the cool. What are people's thoughts on it? Do they think it's better than the first one? Comparable? More corpses. Probably don't need to be sneaking as much as I am. It crashes too much, it's a bummer. There's a Bethesda I know and love. Oh, I hit another tripwire, but it was the one I just disabled. Okay, understood. So I guess I could have gone behind that other one and disabled it first. Do that for next time. I like the idea of rats and corpses and how that naturally interacts with a stealth game. It's clever. Greetings, Corvo. Lord Protector, as you were known before that title was wrongfully taken from you. Damn, how long was I in jail? I felt like it was like 3 minutes. Servants of the Empire and of the True Empress, a group of loyalists who want very much to meet you, take these weapons, crafted for you of the finest materials in the Isles, and meet with our man, Samuel, near where these tunnels spill into Renhaven River. All haste and luck, we share a common purpose. I thought that was a manila envelope, I didn't realize that was a suitcase. Oh man, am I going to get a trank dart? Because that would be the bee's knees. Everyone's liking it? Cool. That's always okay if they do small improvements, as long as it's not jumping the shark or worse, right? Quick access wheel tutorial. Hold left bumper to open the quick access wheel. Select the gadget or power you want to equip in your left hand. Press left bumper to confirm. Crossbow as a sleep dart. Hey! Look at all these cool... This is the same way I play Metal Gear Solid. Look at all these cool items I'm never going to use in my non-lethal playthrough. But I have one I'm going to get to actually use. That's exciting. Lord Regent is a shriveled prick and a liar. Gotcha. Hemlock Essence. I like how there's lots of cool pickups, but they all just convert into coins. Plague victim? Do they add more non-lethal options in MGS5? Remember, you play like the main Metal Gear series non-lethal, you're pretty much using the Trank Dart. that's it. CQC can be pretty fun in Snake Eater. Do sick stealth ninja flips into things. That's cool defense. Can appreciate that for sure. Making sure that I open that thing. Oh, that's a reason to use the spy. That's cool. Clever. Get them jellied eels. Jelly, in case you're too daft to remember, look to your whiskey for the answer. Whiskey, got it? If you want your share, you'll sort it out. I'll come back for it next month. Combination recorder. Okay, so he should have a whiskey bottle here somewhere. It has the safe combination on it. It might be the guy that was dead outside. Let me go take a look. Where is the whiskey? That's not it. No dumping allowed. Where's the bottom person? Drain to the Renhaven. Yeah, I agree. You don't need the complexity of having all different sorts of things you have to sell later. Just make them into coins, but you can still be excited about. Because pickups are flavorful as much as anything, right? Oh, here we go. 4-5-1. Well hidden. Hooray! We got a jewel box and some books. Protagonist isn't a big reader. Main drain.
He won't get past me, sir.
About that.
You know who we're hunting here? Don't try to take him out alone.
But what if no one from the squad is around?
Then try to make a lot of noise when you die. Knock something over if you can.
Bastard.
Don't do that. That would be awful. Whatever you do, don't do that.
Smells like a dead weeper in here.
What's a weeper? Ooh. I love these. Getting used to a new universe and all the nouns are like, oh, what does that mean? There's another guy down here. Oh, that's delightful. He's taking a whiz.
They come here to die sometimes in the dark. Just slip into the water, don't come out. Hey, what was that? No, I heard something.
But you can't get up here.
I'll get to the bottom of this. What in the void was that?
The void, huh?
I know.
I don't know who he was talking to before. Or where he was talking. So when we talk about rats eating guards, we're talking about those, like, swarms of rats eating guards, right? Individual rats aren't a big deal? Or do they just tend to do damage to anything that's nearby? No loot. Save. Things have been going well. Okay, cool. I thought you guys meant swarms of rats at first. I was worried about anywhere that seemed even slightly dirty. Oh shit.
You're gonna bleed.
Takes them a while to actually fall out, right? Well, that was my first time getting detected, but we used up all our sleep darts and everything's okay now. See if I can luck out enough to find more of them later. I've learned that the guards actually do look up, is what I got from that encounter. I wasn't 100% sure if I was fairly safe from detection when I was above them. It does not appear to be the case. We don't want to leave them to be eaten alive by the rats. If they do get eaten alive by the rats, that counts against us. Now, is a little red icon around my reticle, does that mean that I'm still detected? What does that mean? Right? All the sleep darts gone forever. Copper wire, sink. Hey, there's still like these red lines around the reticle. I wonder if I should reload. Hiding in the waterworks. Okay, come now. Oh, cool. Alright. Just saved before that segment, so I can feel comfortable trying this. Any bottles over here? I think I lost the only one. Yeah, that's a... Let's unload the area of the sewers behind you. Drop right there. But I can't, like, pick up a rock and throw it. Try to grab their attention by, like, attacking. Right, here we go. They don't behave quite the way I expect to investigating, like, loud sounds. They don't just, like, walk over to the source of the sound. I really like this peeking behind corners mechanic. It's a little silly. I think they'd be able to see you. But I think it's one of those, it's like a mechanics abstraction.
Hey, I don't need shit from you.
Yeah, they don't really investigate those, do they? So seepy. There's several of them up here.
What the void was that?
Like this, right? I'm technically behind cover. Just my imagination. That's so fun. It's like so silly, but it works, right? Come on, walk, turn around. There's another guard around the corner there. I don't know what his patrol route looks like.
What happened? Whacked in the head? Oh, he's here. Hey.
Shit. Womp womp. Yeah, right. It's third-person stealth games where you get to cheat. No, I'm totally on board with it. It's a clever mechanic, right? It doesn't make sense, but it doesn't need to make sense because at the end of the day, the character is stealthier than you are as the player, and you need to give the player some kind of supernatural ability to simulate that. Otherwise, it's not really fair. Should investigate. Maybe it just gets them to turn around. It doesn't actually get them to go check what the sound was. I think that's what's actually going on here. Is there some pipes here I can climb up, maybe?
Very felt.
Shit. Well, we're gonna try it one more time. This has like been the hardest stealth section. I don't know the solution for this area. Maybe I'm supposed to use the sleep darts. I'm trying to do it while conserving my sleep darts. If I can't do it after this attempt, I'll just sleep dart them. It's because I really can't get them to behave the way I want. Maybe it's swimming. As you mentioned, you're usually safe from detection while underwater. Guess I also don't need to take out every guard, right? That's a much easier solution, but there is a thing that I skipped back there that I'm going to want to go back to. But I might actually be able to reach it now that I'm on the other side. So let me save from this side and think about how I'm going to do it. This game's really cool. Okay, I just had bad timing from when he was steering on the bridge last time. Okay, we just want to go right out there, I think. Well, not like that. I think it's because when I'm loading up my game, I'm not in stealth mode, so I'm walking over the grating and it's too loud and they hear it, right? That's what's getting me in trouble. I think I need to take them out so I can check out that secret door, because it requires me attacking the wall, which is probably going to make too much noise, you know? Alright, let's see. If he pats back over that way, this guy's going to come over here now. The other guy's not padding in this direction at the moment. So, like, if you drop them in water, I assume that they'll drown and die, right? So you don't want to do that if you're trying to not kill anybody. Sleepy, sleepy. Okay. Progress. I'll try to keep an eye on water. It's hard for me to gauge the depth of water because they try to go for this really fancy, like, surface effect rather than letting you see underneath. Is most water... Is there such a thing as, like, very shallow water in this game? Or not really? Oh, where'd that guy come from? There should only be three guards total in here. Maybe yelled, he woke him up. Is that how it works? Wow. Y'all are... Should come investigate it, dude. Dude, investigate the noise. Oh my god. So does the little alert icon around their head mean anything? Like, does it stay lit up and then it's slowly drained to dark, and does that mean, is that how much time they're going to be looking for you, basically?
Still crying about that dice game? I don't need shit from you.
Okay, so I think that's a safe opportunity to get him in the future. I go for it. There we go. It's like their awareness meter. And it is draining, right? It goes from all the way full, which means they're really alert, to like darker and darker, which means they've lost interest, basically. Oops. Hello. Although he's not actually going to come investigate. I hope that that changes later. I'm used to being able to, like, lure guards out. It's a different way to do stealth, right? Try to get their attention, lure them out, sneak behind them, and grab them. But it seems like getting their attention just makes them face you. That doesn't really change where they move to. First try. Wow. That took way too many attempts. But I think I'm a little bit more familiar with the game mechanics. It was good practice, the first difficult stealth encounter. Basically, use water to your advantage whenever possible. Try to get behind groups if you can. Yeah. Yeah, that's... And I had to spend that entire segment learning about patrol routes versus luring. I'm so used to luring being a thing. That's cool, though. It makes it feel different. Because, like, luring them is almost too easy. Verticality is a big thing. Hey, welcome back, Chaos. Yeah, I thought that when I first got into that area. I guess it's true for being in the water. It looks like they look up decently. Like, their cone of sight extends upward a teensy bit. It's here by the Wren Haven. I'll make my last home. It stinks to the void. My grandmom's hagfish stew will drive the odor away. I remember sailing out on this river to the great ocean, that vast blinding light and blue water. I was a tender 15 and our nets were always full to bursting. The old days before everything went to shit. Any way it goes is either the boots of the watch against my skull, the feet of the rats in my bones, or the teeth of the rats in my bones, it's worse. Or the trembles of the plague all over my skin. Don't matter none to me. Get more cool lore. Nothing else of terrible important here. I don't yet know the meaning of the little skull graffiti everywhere. It's the probably secret assassin society that I'm in the middle of joining. Rebels against the regent. Supporters of the true empress, yada yada yada. Alright. Yeah, it's really cool. It's a very different take on a stealth game from what I'm used to. I was just talking as you walked in. It's a lot more focused on exploiting enemy patrol routes and being patient and learning what they do rather than trying to just lure them out of their patrol route and punish them for it. That makes it quite a bit harder.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. The assassin Corvo, responsible for the murder of our fair empress and the disappearance of Lady Empress, plague bodies. Heir to the throne, has temporarily escaped. The universe, art design, everything about it's really cool. It's neat to see a game that was inspired by Bioshock. Like, I always love seeing when games are inspired by each other, as obviously as this one was.
Samuel, and I work for some good people who want very much to meet you. They said you'd come out here, but I could still hardly believe it. I'll take you to meet them. Just down the river from here.
Sleepy kitties. Alright, I think I found all the loot I need to find.
Around if you need.
Unless if there's some loot out here.
Just don't take too long.
Don't go swimming in this water. This is game over water, right? I'll save first. It's not game over water. Hooray! Oh, it is game over water. There's hagfish. Okay, so they're like piranhas, I guess. Gotcha. Clever. Is there a tell that there's hagfish in water? Is it whenever there's the moss in there? There is a chest in this water? Alright. Well, I save and go look for it. Totes is, you know. Coins, monies. That's a cool secret. So, the game has secrets, too. That's pretty neat. So that's cool. There's a hagfish mechanic and a rats mechanic, so you could use those. Look at that. Look at the whale on that ship. That's really cool. I love secrets.
Get in. We've got a hot meal and a warm bed waiting.
You can see hagfish shadows. Okay. You can tell there are hagfish in the water by there being water. Sleepy kitties. Alright, hostiles killed zero. Civilians killed zero. Alarms rung zero. Dead or unconscious bodies found zero. Overall chaos low. Is low the lowest value for that? Didn't kill anyone. Checkmark. Ghost never detected. Oh. Alright, well, we're not doing a ghost playthrough. I guess never detected means... Because I feel like I loaded my save enough times that... I never actually had to use combat to take anybody out. But does that mean that they can't ever get the little detection thing over their heads? Or how exactly does that work? Discover the hermit's room, open the jelly safe, found this sunken treasure. Ooh, and there's a bunch of collectibles. You can try to find all of the coins in the level. We found 787. That's pretty neat. Yeah, I'm not going to do that. Don't worry. What are the rules for it? They can't see you at all. Wow. That sounds very difficult. Seriously? How would I have avoided that then? I just had to start running immediately or hidden in the... I guess that was what the trash can was supposed to be for, right? Place the bomb and then hide in the trash can and let the guards leave. I thought that was just a scripted event. Gotcha. So there's alternate puzzle solutions there.
The watch will break in with swords drawn. And now that you've escaped, the Lord Regent's going to be tearing the city apart.
Gotcha. So if you want to do a ghost playthrough, you have to take very specific routes for scripted events like that. And it probably involves a lot of reloading, right?
If anyone can help you find that missing girl, Lady Emily, and clear your name, he can.
Is this game good about telling you whether you're on track to get that reward? Is there like a thing you can see in the menu that reveals that, or do you only see it when the level's over? I guess I can look right now. Objectives, notes. I never looked at my inventory. Keyring. Gadgets. It's Corvo's crossbow. I guess somebody gave it to me. Hidden allies in an old bar on the river. Your new allies have plans to share with you. Mission clues. Mission items. Oh, it doesn't tell you? Oh, that's messed up. Achievement unlocked. Dishonored. That was a really neat first level. I liked having the hide and seek thing to teach you stealth. I like the rat mechanic. I said the art style of this game and just its presentation is not what I was expecting. I had in mind something a lot more grimdark, but it's much like brighter and prettier. Which I appreciate we've moved on from, like, you know, browns and grays and excessive bloom. Oh, it's a lot of... Oh, those are boats. I thought they were coffins. Makes more sense. This is a pretty big area. That's cool. Alright, I'll go do the quest for now. I'm sure I'll get a chance to explore it later. How cordoned off is this game? Like, I assume I'm never going to go back to that prison, so you only have one chance. Like, if you get that screen, that means whatever area you were just in cannot be revisited, right? Can you revisit areas or not once you get that screen? Later, Nodovan. Yeah, I'm digging it so far. We're going to be playing Dishonored for another hour and a half, and then when my wife Andrea gets home, we'll boot up Jackbox games. Viewers can play along on your phone, laptop, computer, any device with a browser, and it is free to join.
Best join them.
They're revisiting these
reapers. Really killed the Empress.
Even after 6 months in Coldridge prison, he slipped out like it was nothing. All he had to do was load his save like 10 times. He was the personal bodyguard of the Empress. 15 times.
We can continue this later, Lord.
Should have listened to the rest of that.
The man of the hour is here.
Corvo, hey guys.
I'm Admiral Havelock, a true servant of the Empire, like you. Until the Lord Regent purged those of us who wouldn't recognize his claim on the throne.
And I'm Lord Trevor Pendleton.
I represent Trevor Pendleton.
Our little group. But we all act as equals here at the Hound Pits Pub.
This is a momentous occasion.
Hound Pits Pub.
I'm going to come out with it. We've been building a coalition of loyalists, aimed at ending the Lord Regent's tyranny and restoring the throne.
At risk of execution, we're committed to finding young Lady Emily and seeing her crowned as Empress.
We've got big plans, but we can't do any of it without you. We need your skills, your ability in a fight, and in helping us, we're going to help you destroy the men who murdered the Empress.
Sorry, you must be exhausted. We can discuss this further after you've recovered.
But no, we can talk more. You
should introduce yourself to Piero.
Piero, yeah, sure. Times,
but his industrious mind buys him that right.
It's Hugo Weaving looking motherfucker over here on the left.
Yes. Piero's as much an artist as a technician. He's going to be crafting the gear you'll need. Go talk to him and then get some sleep.
A lot of ugly dudes in this universe. Secret coin, man. I kind of play this off stream and try to hunt down all the coins. It would be fun. Wait, what just happened? That was weird. Can I get some, like, peanuts? I'm also curious to find out if coins are just collectibles. Oh, man. Chains do not behave the way I would expect them to. Like, I'm pressing forward to climb down. They behave according to the direction your camera is pointed. Which I don't know if I've seen a game do that before. It's weird. Get that whale oil. Cool.
If I may, I am the personal assistant to Lord Pendleton, and one of the senior servants at Pendleton House.
Your voice does not match your face, dude.
Now I am entrusted with this house, the home of the Loyalists. I have never seen the Admiral fail at any venture. If order can be restored to the city of Dunwall, I believe he can do it. If anyone can get your old life back, it's him.
Yeah, that's how, like, Half-Life 1 does it. I guess I don't know, trying to like call to mind what the natural behavior for a chain or a ladder I would expect to be in a first person game. Maybe it's not as weird, but I definitely get on it and press a button and he doesn't do what I expect him to do automatically.
The Navy under the Empress, but something happened with the Lord Regent that drove the Admiral out, if I understand it right.
I like that this game isn't just constant stealth levels. That makes it pretty different from something like Metal Gear Solid as well, right? Metal Gear Solid, you're always sneaking. You're not like going through a sewer that doesn't have too many enemies for a long period of time or going to a town with allies to talk to. That's pretty cool. I think games benefit when they're not always on with whatever their cell is, you know? Downtime's important.
Blood on their face and chest area. The only way to help them is to bring them to the city watch. They will be taken to the flood district for treatment.
I'm gonna die. That looks like a makeable jump. I can never tell. Platforming in first person, even in games that are well done, like Metroid Prime. Oh, that was not the right way.
Oh my!
What's up?
Ah, you could only be Corvo. I suppose you're practicing for your... Well,
that's me. You heard about me?
You're much younger Boo. Than I expected.
Just pop around a corner.
Do make yourself at home. Terrible. You got blamed for the death of the Empress. Rest her spirit.
It was terrible, wasn't it? Can't climb up poles.
I'm sorry it's so dark. We can't risk being seen.
Oh, I see. So I could pick her pocket because I don't want to kill her. Now, I guess I could kill all the NPCs in this game, which I'm totally not going to do. What will we do with the drunken whaler? Feeding the hungry rats for dinner. Hey, hey, up and she rises. Slice his throat with a rusty cleaver. Stuff him in the sack and throw him over. That's cool. I was wondering, I was like, what's the point of pickpocketing if you always get the stuff? But that makes more sense now.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. Be advised.
Can you ever get punished for pickpocketing? Like, is she gonna know if I go talk to her again? Hey, you took my key. What a purveyor of chaos you are.
Any items recovered from doing so are
from the series of Overseer Invocations by High Overseer Abram Templeton. And I say to you, brothers, it's here that we make our stand as a righteous force against the growing darkness. This would be a JRPG thing, if we trust the Overseers. It's here that we unite against the spirits of the unknown that would drag us screaming in the night and never return to our homes, to our families. Together we will serve as a rod to those who would stray from the herd, the foggy gray ways to the outsider. Okay. We'll burn a bright fire with our virtuous actions so that others will not lose their way, and to those who choose to wander beyond the walls of our homes and far places, we will strike at them swiftly before they whisper to their neighbors, filling their hearts with strangeness and doubt. Yeah, okay. Chaos is just violence.
Oh, I could tell okay, good stories about that, believe me.
So if a door doesn't say unbreakable door, you can technically like take it down by... Wait, seriously? Oh, okay. By just attacking it? There's a lot of books in this. Finding my way with the feeble light of the dying fire, I saw her working. A large needle moved in her hand, following precise, esoteric patterns. Knots and loops of seamstress craft from ancient days. Beneath her needle, his body clenched and shuddered, shaking the wooden table. Ah, okay. A morbid fascination pushed me closer until she turned her blank face toward me, resting the needle in his flesh. With a refined tone, she addressed me, "So you are the lover, I presume. You too have been unfaithful, and now it is your turn to be mended." Great! Fantastic. Excerpt from a theater play. Because you can attack the rats. Lord Nathan Bale, shaking with outrage. "How dare you, sir, clothe so in my very home. I should hand you over to the watch to brave Tibian." Prince Kalasar moving close. Prince Kalasar. So, okay, no, it's not. "It's a harsh welcome for royalty, my lord. Your daughter treated me with much more hospitality. Alas, she's gone out for the evening, leaving me all alone." "What are you doing? Leave this house. Go back to your frozen wasteland, pale rascal." Interesting. "Your skin is so warm, it burns." Setting us up. Gaffer's Tale. It's about Samwise Gamgee's dad. Okay, so the plague has been around for a while now, it sounds like. Fair amount of reading material in there. Okay, I'm gonna take their plates. Shit's worth money, man. You got room for it. Hey, sorry, dude, you come in here, Hugo Weaving. Steal your shit.
"Please breathe two bottles of Dunwall Red, never mind which, and fetch a clean glass. Well, I'll begin again tomorrow."
Cool.
"Log entry 1-4. It seems we've looked..."
Oh, so sometimes there's multiple copies of the same book. Should I think of the books in this game like, I think I've used my words here. Should I think of the books in this game like critical, unusually placed codex entries, like in something like Bioshock with the audio logs? Or are they more like Skyrim where there's just hundreds and hundreds of them, and if you wanted to immerse yourself in the lore, it's going to take you forever to read all of them? Because I'll take the time to read them if there's not tons and tons of them, but if there's like, you know, lots of them, then I might just move on. Unless if there's a particular cool one, y'all are welcome to point it out. I like the lore in them. It's more like Skyrim? Okay, thank you. If I weren't streaming the game, I would definitely take the time to read each one. But since we're focusing on beating lots of games, I don't think it's going to add a lot of value to the Dishonored playthrough to spend that time.
I don't need to tell you. If the authorities investigated this,
that's cool.
We'd be hard pressed to explain ourselves.
Yeah, I appreciate that they go to that effort. Try making that jump again, maybe.
You can call on Cecilia for the more menial tasks. It's what she's suited for.
Don't be mean to Cecilia.
Suited for. Curfew extends from sundown to sunrise.
You are dressed as a maid.
Otherwise authorized.
Be nice.
Will be subject to interrogation and detained when necessary.
Okay.
Remember, the boldest measures.
Nice. So we are in some kind of dystopia. That was the only reason to come up here. I love these kinds of secrets though, those are fun. I like the game's pretty good at like funneling you to whatever you were trying to do. Pretty critical in these sorts of first-person games, you know? Probably gonna come out of this door later, aren't I? Something bad's gonna happen and I'm gonna have to run along this path away from bad shit. Video games, alright.
I'll be crafting your weapons and gear.
Ooh.
For you, I will create the tools of a master assassin.
Not quite as overwhelming as Skyrim, okay. Yeah, I'll peek at him. I'll try to skim him. But like I said, if I get to one that's really cool and I don't give it enough attention, just let me know and I'll read it more closely. Sokolov technology. That's the... We met Sokolov earlier, didn't we? And we have some of his health potions. They share the same magnetic socket for the tanks and process whale oil. They use as fuel. When a tank is exhausted, another can be plugged into the place with ease. Process is simple enough that any common workman or even the lower guardsman of the city watch can handle the task. Arc pylon and wall of light security systems, cool. Powered carriages used for transport. Later, Yahan, I hope you feel better. Star chart. Oh, that's cool. It just counts as coins. But again, it's like a really neat flavor thing. Instead of just having everything be coins, you can see this neat star chart and see, oh, this is worth money here. That's interesting.
That one is empty. A new tank, please.
New tank, okay. Like, you can play around with the stuff in the workshop. It's really cool. Sokolov's formula. Pyra's remedy. Okay, so everyone's scrambling to cure the plague. How's it been treating you? Not sign off on these purchases. Bag of powdered crystal, tibia and ore. What's wrong with the metals and crystal? Yeah, so I think like if it's a note like this, it's more important to read than the lore building books is how I'm gonna approach it. This is my bar. What's left of it? We're operating on a budget. We're running low on oil, food, elixir, building materials, and everything else. You've got to slow down. Half the season ruins, I wasn't missing any of the old crap you seem to need. Stealing your shit. What's up with that? That's kinda cool. Oh man, don't tell me if there is, but I'm suddenly wondering if there's anything supernatural in this universe. So far it's like, you know, steampunk science fiction. Whale vivisection. 42 feet in length, yikes. The mass of tentacles around her mouth? Interesting. Wasn't expecting tentacle whales. Wait. Could these hooks with lens cast? So we'll have no longer has the upper hand with regard to supplies of whale oil. Good Admiral is paid for the installation of my own system, which will enable me to work in this place. OK. Okay. Got it. Put the empty tank in the thing.
Perfect. Now plug it in.
Can do.
Just get it near the root.
Yay, magnetism. Portal filtering. Portal 2 did this thing where it, when you aim at a portal, it tries to filter you into them without you having to aim perfectly, and I love games that do that sort of thing. Feels much tighter controls.
Can you see normally?
Oh, cool. I don't know, I got a kick-ass
there. Better now?
Mask. I saw that on the box art, but I thought that was the bad guys.
Upgrades for your gear, weapons, munitions. But our situation here is desperate. Scavenge the city for valuables, and I will resell them on the black market. That should give us the money.
Okay, that's why it's been converted into money so far.
Tell me cool. What I can make for you.
Let me save before I check out his menu here.
You must be exhausted. I advise that you get some sleep. Your life will get even more difficult soon. You should rest while you can. Very well. You know best. Let me know if you need anything more.
Okay. Save. Totally tubular titles on the Virtual Console. Thanks, Wii U.
Tell me what I can make for you.
Yes, please. Let's have a look. Rewire tool. All consumable? Alright, let's not mess around with consumables right now. Equipment upgrades, mask optics, magnify your view. That's cool. That's like a skull mask. Bullet capacity. Bolt capacity. Bone charm? I'll have to find out what that is, I guess. We could have crossed that Rubicon yet. Let's see. Immediate even in combat. That's pretty cool. Master further. Immediate's probably not terribly necessary. I'm gonna go for the mask optics. The bolt capacity I don't think matters just yet. Cool. Can I bring this empty one back up top and refill it? Is that the point they were trying to make earlier? I can. Tank, pull lever once, wait for tank to fill, remove tank carefully. Okay. Man. They really make the whale oil look awesome. Heroes Workshop key needed. Okay. I feel like there are very few universes that focus on whale oil as the main source of. Hey, and he opened his shutters now. Cool. So he wanted you to talk to him up here first. That makes sense.
My break with the academy was.
There's your key, buddy.
I had to rebuild from scratch, but so much the better. I was sick of using tools made by lesser men.
I speculate that a human being might, by a process of adaptation, produce high-energy humors in the body. I could build a tank that would slowly increase pressure on a subject over a long period of time, and then observe them for years if need be, to see if the formulation of energetic substances develop. Surely the Empress would be able to furnish me with facilities subject to the necessary legal amnesty.
Yeah, legal amnesty. I don't know about this Piero guy.
Tell me what I can make for you.
Okay, I guess I have to go somewhere else to go to sleep. He just gave me a chance to do it for free earlier. Without having to walk back to my bed manually like some kind of caveman. Victorian caveman. There's still a few other things I'd like to check out. I really like the exploration component in this game. I wasn't expecting that either. I was expecting a more, like, linear progression. And more back-to-back action sequences.
Once served under Admiral Havelock, Captain Havelock then. I don't know if he remembers me, but I fear it's rude to ask. I don't want to embarrass him.
I need to get a sense of how high I can jump and climb normally. I think it's a bit higher than I expect. Like, yeah, I wouldn't have expected to be able to jump on that one right there. Or that guy. I'll go to sleep now. Bad shit going on at night? I wake up in the middle of the night. What? That's pretty cool. Oh, I love that there was no fanfare for that, right? You just wake up, you see some holes in the floor. Man, that's good. Games are... I feel like developers are terrified that you're not going to see their cool shit. And they tend to present things using cutscenes instead of just letting you walk out and see it and look around. Like, I think you have to take the risk that the player is not going to see your cool thing, you know? It's so much better when you're actually in control during this sort of event.
Hello, Corvo.
What's up, dog?
Your life has taken a turn, has it not?
You know, there is a little bit of supernatural something, right? Well, I guess I don't know if the shadow ninjas are supernatural or if they're using some kind of science thing.
You will play a pivotal role in the days to come. For this, I have chosen you and drawn you into the void.
Void?
I am the outsider, and this is my mark. There are forces in the world.
Interesting.
Great forces that we call magic.
Well, there we go. The long search is over.
Use this newfound power. My gift to you.
Thanks, dude. You seem like a nice guy.
Come find me.
This totally isn't like a dangerous bargain, right? Press left trigger to execute a fast and stealthy forward dash through the world. You can use it to move upward, but the distance is reduced. Aim at ledges allows you to blink forward and climb up? That's cool. Well, I think you're like Victorian ninja. Victorian magic ninja. Alright, so this game just took on an entirely new dimension. I didn't know that this was a thing at all. Use left trigger to target your destination with precision. A blue sphere indicates you should reach your destination. Blue arrow indicates you will climb up when you reach your destination. That's pretty sweet, I gotta admit. Cool. I mean, like, missing some of the floating stuff off in the distance, Spikey. Yeah, you can create the level in such a way that you're forced to notice some of it, but... Like, some people are like, hey, we spent all this time on these art assets, so we're gonna do a cutscene that shows you absolutely everything you could possibly look at to make sure you see all of it. The controls on that feel really good, too. Tracer. Yeah, it removes some of the angst of platforming in first-person view, right? Oh, man. It was a dream fall, so everything's okay, right? Yeah. Watch your step. I like the sound effect, like the whisper he's making. Okay. Okay, Hugo Weaving is angry. Hugo Weaving kidnapped Emily? What's going on here? Emily's letter. Oh, cool. Corvo, I'm very sad. They say you're dead like mother, but I'm going to put this note in a bottle and throw it into a river because I don't believe them. Living here is very strange. I don't like it, so please come for me if you can. That might not actually be Hugo Weaving. It just might be that there's a ton of people in this world who look like Hugo Weaving. Because yeah, it's very tightly controlled, propagable. Especially with a controller, you get some nice force feedback when you're holding it down. I think it controls... It's a lot easier to expect what it's going to do and predict what it's going to do than like Tracer and Overwatch, and that's really well done as well. This is cool. So the void... needs it to go down. Thank you, folks, for not spoiling this stuff. Oh, what's with those dudes? Oh, man, we haven't even begun to scratch the surface of this game, huh? Man, I gotta give mad props to Dishonored. He's like to climb. Okay, here we go. For not blowing their load with this, so to speak. Oh, the cats just ran away. They thought I was about to get fed. Not like giving away this stuff in the first 5 minutes, you know, like making you spend an hour or two thinking it's you know, okay, traditional steampunk stealth mechanics, that's cool. Oh shit! Magic. Tall mech people. Rad.
In the days that follow, your trials will be great. Seek the ancient runes bearing my mark in the lonely places.
This is one of those situations where I feel like I've been rewarded for not hyping myself about this game or looking about anything, not watching any videos. Powers beyond those of other
men. To help you find these runes, I give you this. The heart of a living thing, molded by my hands.
That sounds great. Thanks, man. I've always wanted one of those. How did you know? I can see that propagable. Even just like the moving around the town we were just in for collectibles felt like exploring around in Half-Life 2. Thanks for the clockwork heart. Equipping the heart in your left hand helps you locate bone charms or runes. I guess they kind of gave away the bone charms thing with the upgrade menu. The heart beats and lights up when you're facing a bone charm or rune, and it beats faster as you get closer. It whispers secrets if you press left trigger while targeting a person or location.
This place is the end of all things, and the beginning.
That's pretty neat. Okay, so spiritual remedy is an ether. Got it.
All of time's meaning is here. Neither seconds, nor centuries.
Yeah, and it's something where, like, I feel like developers tend to make their games with surprises in mind, and they're just disconnected usually from the marketing team, which will be like, oh yeah, this is a rad game about teleporting around, being a ninja wizard. I'm like, oh man, I kind of wanted that to be a surprise, but okay. How else are you going to get people to play your game, you know? Guessing I'm not gonna usually get a little objective marker at the same time as this thing. Yeah, right. That makes sense. Way down there.
Someday this place will devour all the lights in the sky.
Well, that's great. Hey, lovely.
Which one?
This game's called Dishonored. It is a steampunk Victorian ninja wizard game.
I like all of them.
Yeah, no, right? This is my wife, Andrea. Hold on, let me zoom out the webcam here. Sneak over to the right here. You excited for Jackbox?
Yeah.
Cool. We're going to be playing for about another hour or so before we switch over. Yeah, it's a cool mechanic. How was science today?
Science was pretty good. I was just thinking, like, so I'm gonna go to a conference next week in Santa Fe, and I should figure out if we can, like, get on the speakers to play my Andrea Hype song before I go to give my talk.
Here comes science. Everyone wants an Andrea Hype type song in science.
It's a great song. Like, if I, play baseball. You remember that we went to that game in Bristol, the minor league game, and they all had their own pump-up music and they come up to that? Yeah. I do that.
How does mana regen work in this game? So, like, clearly it's regenerating, but it's stopping at a certain point. Can someone just explain that mechanic?
Yep, everyone at the conference would judge me immensely. And then they would just be jealous.
Once you've collected runes, open the journal and go to the power section to exchange them for powers. Powers? What? Cool. Blink. Rapid forward movement for a longer distance. Cost 3 runes. Dark vision. See in the dark and see living beings through walls, including their fields of vision.
Ooh.
What? That sounds pretty sweet.
You have to
I was gonna
a
say
lot
like
of stealth in this game.
Yeah, it's like a stealth game, but it's very. It's like you played Arkham Asylum for a bit, right? Where it's like, yeah, you can be stealthy, but you know you're still Batman.
Right.
You're still a ninja wizard. Health is increased.
But you still have to stealth.
I don't think so.
Oh, you can just kill everyone.
I assume so.
Okay.
I mean, it's a moral decision if you want to be a murderer or not.
Hey, man.
I'm playing it stealthy right now.
Yeah,
I want
this
dark
me,
vision. That sounds
so
pretty great.
It's their moral decision the whether or not they want to be alive.
Oh, I see. Since using the second power cancels region. So, what's, Can you completely deplete your mana? I imagine not. Like, it has to regen some amount if you need blink to progress, right? Press left trigger to see in the dark and reveal living beings through solid walls. You can also see their fields of view as well as a visual representation of the sounds you make. Level 2 shows you important items like security devices, weapons, ammo, coins, keys, or traps. Yeah, that sounds great. Let's save up for part 2.
How you use what I have given you falls upon you, as it has to the other.
You can totally run out of mana.
And now I return you to your world, but know that I will be watching with great interest.
This is like a fantasy world where the plague is a big problem, so there's these plague rats everywhere that like will try to eat you and like, eat corpses if you leave them behind, if you want to be a bad person.
Do they still think the plague was spread by rats?
I don't think so.
Is it the fleas on the rats?
This game's also very heavily inspired by Bioshock. Like,
yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, right?
The hand.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like going around
and
picking up things.
Salts.
And, yeah, exactly.
What are salts here?
Well, it's just been foods. I just got magic as you walked in.
Oh,
I didn't even know magic was in this game. I was like, oh shit, okay, that's cool. Right on. Samuel, then? If you like, but he won't use it. Why? Turn on. He can't sleep in regular beds anymore. That's what he says. Says he was in the Navy too long. Can you believe it? Oh, that pile of wood out there? It's a hovel he built from an old road. That'll help me with telling if I can jump down from somewhere or not.
Good day, Master Corvo.
Sup?
Oh, like, she just asked you a question, bitch, and you just fucking walk away? That's rude. Who the fuck is that?
Hey, Wallace.
Wallace.
Are you a nobleman, Corvo?
No one seems to know much about you.
By your bearing, I'd say so. Lord Pendleton's great-grandfather took a Sokonan chambermaid to wife. Second thought that doesn't bear repeating. Even the finest blood can go bad here and there.
I can point the heart at people.
What does the heart do?
Somewhere in the basements below, Hound kills Hound, and money changes hands.
Aww, dog vice!
And then reports to the overseers.
Interesting.
There's a little Tivian blood in the Pendleton line.
Whispers secrets to you. No one's gonna question me about this cool clockwork heart, right?
She hides her hands. They are raw and scarred from the wash.
Lord Trevor's pure as the Empress herself.
I forgot about the heart, thank you. It's a really important thing to use. There's other people to show this to.
Such laughter. And then they're singing the old songs, linking arms.
There's a rune out there. I want that rune. Hopefully I don't trigger a story event. Ah! Oh shit!
You're fine. Walk it off. Just walk, you'll be fine. You're fine, walk it off.
Okay, there's falling damage in this game. That's the first time I've taken it. I'll just eat some chips later.
Exactly. That always makes you feel better after falling.
Inertia sucks!
I know, right?
Deals are made here. Sometimes under the influence of wine. And sometimes the influence is the point of a knife.
I triggered that. Hey. Sweet. No other runes. I'm glad that it gives you a little marker. I mean, the beating thing is neat too. Hi, Ben. He's very hungry. I'll feed you after we finish Dishonored when we switch to Jackbox. Don't worry.
I don't know why he's hungry. Did you tell him all what he did last night?
No, I didn't. I woke up at 4 in the morning to the sound of cabinets slamming open and things rustling to find. So we have child locks on all our cabinets. Oh, God. Piranhas. We have child locks in all our cabinets because he will open them all and try to eat everything. Like, he tries to eat the waffle mix.
Yeah.
We did it when I first heard meowing coming from the freezer and he was in there eating our frozen waffles. Anyway, I went outside. I went outside and he had taken out the loaf of bread and had taken a bite out of every piece of bread.
Nope.
He didn't eat, like, one piece of bread. He just bit every one of them.
Yep.
Son of a bitch. Some people's cats.
He also got into the Cheetos and the pretzels.
You can watch him. Don't let him get on the earthbound box so he'll knock it over. He's doing fine right now where he is.
Yeah. Yeah. There you go.
Tough love. Spaghetti sauce? Aw. It's adorable. Do not attempt to howl. I think I already ate all the food that's just lying around here. This is why I'm not healing myself. He hasn't eaten in years. Propagable understands.
Yeah, exactly.
Ben.
By years, you mean hours.
Well, let's get down to it. First off, I know that assassination is dark business, but sometimes good men have to do bad things to make the world right. Our purpose is clear. We want to restore Her Majesty's line by finding and putting Emily Caldwin on the throne. To those ends, we'll hide.
The game opened with us playing hide and seek with Emily Caldwin. She's like 10.
Oh.
It's cute. Teaching you about them stealth mechanics.
Campbell dies by your hand. It won't be easy. He's protected by his overseers, an army of religious zealots. But if anyone can do it, you can. Your exploits are legendary. Campbell carries a private journal. Once you've eliminated him, get the journal, because we think it contains Emily's location. Recovering her is obviously critical, assuming she's alive. That's the gist of it. Remember our cause and strike true. We're counting on you.
Thanks.
Okie dokie.
They busted me out of jail. I got framed. I was the bodyguard for the Empress, and I was there when she got murdered, and then I got framed for it.
That's a bummer.
Corvo. Hello. I'm Callista. I work here for Admiral Havelock. I'm sorry to intrude on your business, but this is important. I suspect you're going to kill the High Overseer.
You're going to give me the alternate option to not do the evil thing?
There's really no reason for you to listen to me. But my uncle, Jeff Kernow, still serves as captain in the City Watch. But he's a good man, and my only family. The chatter in servant circles is that Campbell just took delivery of an exotic poison. And I think I know why. My uncle's not corruptible like the rest of them. Campbell is going to poison my uncle. Do you think you could protect him? You used to do that, right? Before you had your current profession. Before you became an assassin.
I mean, I've been an assassin for like 3 minutes.
Hey, Sailor Man, I'm doing the same thing.
Before the sun rises, they toss any casualties into the river.
Beer. Everybody's drinking their beer.
She is Callista Kernow.
You can kill everyone in this game, I think. Will not be doing because I'm a nice person.
You can't be a nice assassin.
I'm a very nice assassin.
Dude.
He succeeded.
Just wondering, sir, if you thought about perhaps seeing Pierre.
So I don't really drink, but when we do the April Fool's Brostead stream, we're going to do donations for Jaeger shots or something.
You're going to die. We'll make it scale or something. People will pay money to see you do Jaeger shots.
We're going to do Brostead. I'm going to get a clamshell necklace and a baseball cap with a sticker still on it and sunglasses.
Oh.
We're going to ham it all the way up, you know. We're gonna get one of those like special effect things that makes it sound like my voice is echoing when I press on the keyboard. Air horns, dubstep, the works. Butt rock. Hey, I get my cool mask. I didn't realize I wasn't wearing it that whole time.
Oh, you have to get like a poster of like chicks in bikinis washing a car. I'm trying to think of these stupid ass posters that were in like every
propaganda. Okay.
Every guy's room in college.
It you gotta get like, a Boondock you know, Saints poster.
Like, yeah, the Boondock Saints poster, and then, like, the chicks in bikinis washing a car.
Yeah.
Or something like that, yeah.
I gotta replace all this. I was gonna do a green
screen.
Or
the Pulp Fiction poster.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
Half the city's dead of the plague. The other half's fighting over what's left. City Watch still holds the bigger streets, and they've set up those wall of light checkpoints. Man walks through one of those and he ends up burned to a crisp.
Don't walk through the wall of light checkpoints. Got it. You might like this game. It's pretty cool. It's not very hard.
Yeah, I don't like stealth though. But you said I could kill everyone.
You can totally kill everyone.
I could get down with that. Curious to see how many people I can murder.
Rat skewer. Okay, you can just go ahead and answer this question.
Way to pay attention, Dan.
I joked earlier that there's two alignment systems in this game, like how evil you are and how plagued you are. Is that really true? Is there any penalty for me eating rats and rotten pears and shit, or is food just food is food? That's what I look like. I got this cool mask.
I mean, cool it's a skull, mask. So you should be killing
me. I'm a nice guy. People see me like, he
nice
seems like
skull.
A friendly fellow.
Skulls are all evil.
You're wrong about that, okay?
Hey, Dan says food is food.
Food is food.
I can feel a great age ending. He misses the days he spent at sea.
All the guards have custom dialogue?
They are burning whales.
That's cool.
Are they Japanese?
The doom of Pandisia has come to the city.
Pandisia? They kill the rats because they're bad.
Wait, why are you killing this guy?
I'm not.
I'm
knocking him out. I knocked him out. I knocked him out. He's unconscious.
Are you? You're making him pass out in the blood of the plague rat. He's gonna catch.
Yeah, I mean, we have to kind of accept that in video games and movies, you can like, you know, remove the blood flow to someone's brain without killing them, and they can sleep for as long as is convenient.
Is that a kid?
It's a female guard.
Did you murder the child?
It's a lady.
Oh.
It's a lady guard.
Hey, did you tell about the time you stole candy from babies?
I did not tell them about the time I stole candy from babies.
It was really funny. There's a restaurant and it had like candy at the end, but if you took the candy,
like little
peppermints. You had to put like a quarter in. For
I didn't
children.
See the put the quarter for children
it was
thing.
For, it
I
was
thought
for
it
charity.
Was just.
He just took the candy.
I thought, well, there's so many restaurants that have those little, they're like 2 cent peppermints. Maybe not even that.
Yeah, but that one had a please donate to the children. Don't just take the candy.
Better them than us. At least some of them.
So this is kind of cool. It's not realistic, but it's like to simulate that your character
hey,
is stealthier than you are.
One of us.
if you peek out from a corner like this, they can't actually see you. Like, wherever you actually are is what's determined for their sight radius. But if you peek around a corner, who's... Oh, God.
Yeah, I could see myself getting into this game. I'm gonna be honest.
It's cool.
Hey, what's with Hitler?
Hitler?
Is Hitler around? What's with that bird up there? That's a Hitler bird.
Oh, yeah, yeah. There's definitely...
What's with the Hitler bird?
The government that we're part of is not... They're not the nicest people.
And that's why you want to replace him with the 10-year-old?
Yeah. So I think I could, like, warp to him in the future. What do we got over here? Spring razor attack when you attach to any surface by aiming and pressing left trigger. It triggers enemy approaches.
Oh my god.
A cloud of shrapnel. Nope, I'm
did
good.
Did you see the right-hand side?
Did see the right-hand side, yeah.
Shit.
I'm playing non-lethal, so it's the really boring. Like I said, oh, that would be cool if I were playing.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. Just basically make people explode.
All the wall of lights components have been delivered to your station and expected to be functional before midnight. You've also been provided with several spare whale oil tanks should the need arise. Last has come to my attention that various watchmen continue the adolescent practice known as rat burning. Whale oil is not cheap. Please keep your men under control. Whale oil is like the main unobtainium, which is kind of fun. Rewire tool. Disable security devices or make them work in your favor. Harm your enemies instead of you.
See, harm. You didn't say kill. You should get that power.
Whale oil. Nice. How did it pass me by? We got Dishonored about another 50 minutes, and then we'll be doing Jackbox. I'll be taking a short break to go feed the cats, but you can probably just start up without me, right?
Yeah, yeah, I don't need you.
So kind. Mm-hmm. Alright, I'm going to leave this in here. I don't really need the heart at the moment.
Well, I have no idea how to stop the stream or start the stream.
No,
all I know how to do is sit in the chair and play
the game. I'll make sure you're set up for that.
All right, I need you for that.
I appreciate
that part,
the whistling.
All the important parts. It's like I remember when I was a kid. There was this game called Stealth for the NES, where you're like an airplane pilot and you have to go up and like shoot down other pilots, and I could always take off. And I could, like, beat the first level, no problem, kill all the dudes, but whenever I came to landing, I always crashed and died. I have no idea how to land the plane, but I could take off and shoot down other planes really well. I think I got to the second level once, but I don't know what I did to make the plane not crash.
Yes, Ben, you're very free. Possess a rat and use the small tunnel to the left. You can possess rats in this game? What? Must be a power I didn't notice earlier.
Oh, like using, what was the little mouse's name in Dragon Quest VII?
Munchie. Yeah, yeah. That's cool.
Munchie vision!
Oh, okay, so...
Oh, right? Never mind. Landing is hard. Oh, is it based on a movie? I have no idea.
Top Gun's just like that. Gotta watch the Angry Video Game Nerd where he actually successfully lands when using the power glove.
Attention, Dunwall citizens.
That'd be a higher range. Oh shit! Please don't look up.
He gonna see you. How did he not see you?
I'm very sneaky.
No, you're not.
I'm the sneakiest. They're dumb. So it's not that kind of stealth game, Andrea. I got very lucky.
Oh, where do you put the bodies?
You want to put them somewhere where another person's not going to discover them, like that guy down there.
Right. There you go.
Whoa, that was incorrect. That was incorrect what I just did.
Oh yeah, that electricity guy going to see that body.
That means he's alerted, which means I did not...
Raised. Oh, he fucking saw you! Oh, you fucked, man! Oh.
Save's coming!
I wanted to see you try to battle the electricity guy.
I'm not gonna fight anybody. You can fight people, you play it.
So you're like the aliens in Edge of Tomorrow. You just get to keep trying over and over again until you win.
Basically, yeah, that's why it's like a video game movie. I really like this power. It's great. I was complaining about the lack of solids on radar, which is something you have in Metal Gear Solid. This totally makes up for it. That's so cool. I like using the blink.
Yeah,
here.
Yeah, that's perfect. Congratulations, Mega Man. Way to get that achievement trophy.
Good job, dude. There was a dude down here.
What does he say? Something he's, dice?
He's whispering some cool arcane shit, man.
Attention, Dunwall citizen.
I don't know, I don't speak magic.
With an infected or weeping
in there's a rat. You are required to remain. Yeah, we don't know what weeping means yet. It's a proper noun they brought up. Oh, it's one of them weepers. What does that mean?
Someone who's just snapped and really distraught about life. They just cry all the time.
Oh god.
You should kill him.
Half the city's dead. Won't make it 3 more months. I think my wife and I will be able to ride this thing out. The plague has to pass.
Oh, he sees you.
Okay, so regular people, I don't need to knock them out like I've been doing. I hope that doesn't give me a trouble. Alright, it's just guards that I have to worry about. Sorry,
like,
for knocking you out last time.
There's some guy in a fucking death mask.
That was a dick move.
With a knife out. Right, so you're walking around like, you know, stabby stab McStapperson.
Yeah, I didn't know that there were non-hostiles in these levels. It's kind of cool.
Attention, Dunwall citizen.
Is there a way for me to tell clearly? Like, if they have to be wearing guard armor, I guess? Hey lady, what's up? Granny Rags. Whoa!
Where'd she go?
Whoa, she teleported away!
Well,
she must have powers like me. Cool. That was neat. No, she poured it away. It had the little animation.
I told you the knives go on the left. They've always gone on the left. You never listen.
Yeah, Dylan. Here? On the left.
Is that you, my dear husband?
Yeah.
My eyes aren't what they used to be. Have you seen my little birdies? Oh, the dear things must be starving without their granny. Here, birdies. Here.
You're inside. There aren't birds in here.
Oh, my. I think I have gentlemen callers again, but not the way I used to, not the nice ones. I hear them, and they're not very polite ones either.
You know, beggars can't be choosers, lady.
Granny Rags, let us in. Ah, well, they'll go away again if they know what's good for them. But what a bother. Here's the key to the front door, love. You'll see to those ruffians, won't you?
Absolutely.
Sure, why
she
not?
She wants you to kill them.
Deal with Granny's
gentlemen
callers.
With the knives that are on the left.
I think the little birdies are sad today.
Because you aren't killing these guys. Do you think if you killed the guys, that the birdies would be happier?
I don't know.
It's the only one way
stole
to find out.
Stole her war medal. Gotta get money for upgrades. Ooh, sleep darts.
What?
Who's shaking her down?
Don't do that. Why would you do that? You need to stab them.
What's up?
Look at this.
Stabby stab.
You don't walk into Bottle Street looking like that.
With my cool mask.
Maybe I'll let my girlfriend wear it.
Ta-da! You just crossbowed him in the dick.
Well, it was a sleep dart, so it wasn't that big of a deal.
You just sleep darted him in the dick.
I assume I can't take him out without getting detected if I want to do this quest, right? Unless if I can sneak out behind him.
Would you look at this? You don't the bottle street looking like that. That outfit must
There you go. You're the worst assassin ever.
Because I don't kill anyone?
Yes! I mean, that's kind of what your job is. Your job as an assassin is to assassinate, aka kill people.
Try to remember the basics of CQC.
Like.
Garbage, all of it.
Hey, I took care of your gentleman callers. Just don't eat them, please, or whatever weird shit you do.
I knew you'd help me with those ill-mannered boys. My brave man. Listen.
I didn't get detected? Birthday present. Really?
I got it from the outsider, and now I'm giving it to you. Go on. It's upstairs. On the vanity. I think you'll cut a nice figure with it.
You guys should have been detected. How did that work?
We used to dance. Our parties were even grander than those at the Boyle Manor. Everyone wanted to come.
They were cautious but never saw me. That's awesome. Collect your gift from Granny Rags.
Upstairs on the vanity. Upstairs on the vanity. Oh my god, were you not paying
attention? No, I was reading chat.
It's upstairs on the vanity.
Is it on the vanity?
Yeah.
Is that where it is?
What the fuck is that?
I hope you like the little gift I got for you.
I love the rings. They're the best.
Turning those louts away.
No problem. Actually, they're still here. Bottle Street children. They're just unconscious.
Thanks, Odin. Good looking out. Yeah, to subdue the enemy without fighting is the use.
You know what I just thought of? You could do something else for me. Another little.
Yes, Ben, you're very furry. And I'd give He's you right off camera.
Present. Oh, I like another presents.
Lovely rune carved from the bones of a dead whale.
The runes are from the bones of dead whales? Doctor, the whales, they said something about their faces having tentacles on them, so I don't know.
Like Zoidberg!
Yeah. Oh, Zoidberg has the upper hand.
Wouldn't it be a shame if some of that mess found its way into the
professor will be mad, but if Zoidberg fixes it, then perhaps treats.
See to it, dear. I'll find you another present just like the first.
Oh, the guilt. The unbearable guilt. She's like, turkey basters, $10, get your turkey basters. My turkey's dying, I've tried everything. Oh, wait, that's right. You're a little creepy lady.
Alright, do her other thing. Get her room.
I'm going to. Powers. I want to get level 2 this guy. Sounds you make her visible. See useful objects through walls. Yes.
You'll have to go or they won't come.
Dude, I think every episode of Futurama is great.
Oh wow, this is the best. This ability that just shows me all the shit on the map. I am...
Oh, it's like a detective vision.
Exactly, but it costs something, so you don't want to keep it on all the time.
Oh, that's
really
good.
Nice.
Like, I feel like... I thought I was reading something about, like, the best and worst Futurama episodes, and someone was talking about the Naturama one as one of the worst.
I love that episode.
But I love that episode!
That's great.
It's like, because nature is cruel and teaches us nothing. Then the salmon made it to the ocean, the birthplace of all creatures, except the salmon.
Why did they
I want to mate with Beachmaster, because he's the largest.
Why did they die? No reason. There's a couple, in the Comedy Central seasons, there are a couple episodes that feel like a little executive medley. Like, there's one that has Wanda Sykes that doesn't make a ton of sense.
That's my bastard!
There's one that's, like, making jokes about Susan Boyle and, like, the iPhone, and it's like, you guys are in the future, you don't have to joke about current events. But it's still, it's funny.
Susan Boyle one is always...
That's probably the weakest episode.
I would still watch it.
Yeah, it's good. It's just, yeah. It's weak. Weaker. Hi, Ben.
Oh, yeah, the one where the dog died. That
ben,
made me feel things.
Please don't knock the shield over. You don't have to move him as long as he's not standing on anything. My quest is.
You know, the apparently distillery, they right? like rewrote history and made the dog not die or something. I don't remember.
Am I not supposed to go in the distillery?
Yeah, so for the longest time, we would, and still now, we watch Futurama every night before we go to sleep. Because that's what puts me to sleep. Futurama just makes me feel warm and safe. And then I can go to sleep. But apparently I kept sleeping through Jurassic Park over and over again. And then one day I stayed home and I was watching Futurama while Dylan was doing something else at stream. Maybe he was working. And then I watched Jurassic Park and I had no idea what I was getting into. And I got to the end of it and I was just like, Dylan, I need a hug.
I was like, you just now watched that episode finally? I don't know if these guys are... Alright. I wish the little stealth vision lets you know if they were hostile or not. That's me.
Something Dice. Hans Dice? I think he's saying Hans Dice.
Hans Dice?
Maybe okay. It's a German gambler.
They're talking about me like I've been an assassin for like 10 minutes. Like,
you haven't been an assassin ever. You ain't killed no one. You're not an assassin.
But I'm picking up bullets.
You're a fucking nanny. You
That's
put
the
people,
kind of thing
you make
that an
make
assassin
naps.
Would use. I
you
do.
Make people take naps.
That is
makes
exactly
you
what
a nanny.
I'm
an
a nanny mancer. I know, right?
Okay.
I can't disagree with that. You're that's 100% true. I like that I can use this to avoid falling damage. Blink, it feels really good. Okay, we gotta remember to use this heart more often.
Fucking Mary Poppins if she was an assassin.
Bone charm. Used bone charms, yeah.
I tried it once. Distilled from river crusts by the taste of it.
You're a heart. Doesn't mean
she
can't try
drinks.
Wine
snobs is like, oh, these grapes were grown on the eastern mountainside in Tuscany, I can tell.
I'm gonna keep hearing Hans Dice.
Right? It's Hans Dice!
That's exactly what he says.
Yeah.
Hans Dice. I can't disagree with it.
That's true. And then she could just, like, fly away.
Master key.
One looks up.
Kind of shit in there.
Wow, enhanced eyes. I mean, that makes more sense. Yeah, I could. I like Hans Dice better. Hans Dice.
Hans Dice.
Yeah.
God damn it. That is totally what he says.
What, enhanced eyes? I think it's enhanced eyes.
I think it's Hans Dice.
Hans Dice.
Oh shit.
I saw you!
Yes, Ben. Yes, I know you're very furry.
I saw you.
I don't think I can get to the bone charm yet.
Do you ever get a like invisibility spell?
Is that
awesome?
I feel like that would be like the new game plus reward. That's what it is in Metal Gear Solid. Like you get a stealth camo that makes you invisible once you beat the game really, really well.
You gotta check your six, man.
I do. The dead counters come through, and the lawyers are. That's cool. Sleep darts, nice. Once I get a good stock of sleep darts, I can probably progress to these areas a bit faster. Saving them for now.
Ooh, great news! Good news, everyone!
Seriously, dude?
Kami has some good
guy.
News!
Oh, congrats,
I'm
man.
So jealous! Oh my god, we had to drive 45 jelly. Minutes to get to Taco Bell.
Maximum
Tommy,
jelly.
I hope you know how lucky you are. And get that naked chalupa.
I like that as long as you're not spamming abilities, you always
it's
regenerate.
It's in like Saskatchewan.
MP. That's cool. Unless if there's some powers here. Later that are always more expensive, that might also be the case. It's two sleep darts.
Right, Kami, are you in Saskatchewan?
I got the master key. That's what I was looking for. Cool.
We do have dominoes. I do like the dominoes. Domino's is pretty tits. And the McDonald's is tits. And the Subway is tits. No, we don't go to Taco Bell for Mexican food. We go to Taco Bell for American food.
Yeah, Taco Bell's
actually,
not
when
Mexican
we went
food,
to Taco yeah. Bell in Japan, I was like, Dylan, this is what Japanese people think American people think Mexican food is like.
That's pretty spot on.
Saskatchewan. Yeah, sorry about the emphasis. That's just how I know to say it.
Put the emphasis on the wrong syllable.
Is it Saskatchewan? Saskatchewan. Like, am I supposed to like at the end of it, or I don't know. Saskatchewan. I love you too, Ben. Yeah, I hope that you frequent that Taco Bell frequently.
Give them your business, keep them open.
Yep, and when you go to Taco Bell, you should try at least once the Baja Blast. It's a Mountain Dew that you can only get at Taco Bell, and I think it was specifically designed to taste good with Taco Bell.
Alright, where is the distillery? I want to get this bone shard. Yeah, but now I have the key to get in there, so I'm going to try to do that.
What's taco time? Is that Taco Bell? Do they have a crunch wrap supreme? Or a cheesy gordita crunch?
That's funny defense. Oh no, Sailor Dan! I finally convinced Andrew to eat Taco Bell in the car. Like, it's best when it's fresh. The longer you hold it, the worse. But the thought of not drinking your at least a sip of your Baja Blast on the drive home...
Did you ever find yourself? You can take a sip of the soda for sure. There's a couple of things that you can eat in the car. Crunchwrap Supreme, because it's designed to be eaten while driving. Drinks are fine with a straw. And also french fries.
Can I always port to the ground safely to avoid falling damage? That feel like that was longer than what I'm usually able to access. Health elixir. Oh, I'm full on elixirs.
Promise.
Okay, it's good to know that there's a maximum.
You make the correct decision, Yukipo. Having never been to Taco Time. Man, I love me some Taco Bell. That's my favorite part of traveling. Whenever we fly in and out of Albuquerque, I always get Taco Bell on my way out of Albuquerque.
You, it's delicious. The reason you would go to Canada, oh, there's
right?
Multiple copies
crunch
of
Crunch Wrap.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Crunch Wrap, but I really also like the cheesy gordita crunch, but I can't eat that when I'm driving.
The reason you'd be in Canada would probably be for the Perimeter Institute. Dude's
yeah,
taking a leak.
In Ontario. So kill him. He's just, or not kill him.
I'm a nanny, okay? I'm embracing this. Yes, this is a stashing sleepy by nap time room now.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. It made a little sound icon to show that that wasn't quiet.
Right. Dylan here is really into the naked chalupa. If you haven't tried that yet,
it's pretty good.
Yeah. Check it out. They made the taco shell out of chicken. The sauce is pretty good. Ah, so I gotta get into photon light source physics. You know, we're building a new light source here at Los Alamos, out where I work, actually, called Marie.
Oh, he's waking up his friend.
Considering the fact that the Department of Energy is not interested in future gamma ray experiments right now, I might end up having to come up with something else.
Seriously?
He saw you.
I'm gonna use all my sleep darts in here. So sleepy. So tired.
Oh, I'm so tired.
It's a lot of. We're having a big nap party over here. Gamma rays are photons with an attitude problem. Andrea works on an experiment called HAWK, High Altitude Water Cherenkov Telescope. They look for gamma rays from outer space, and they're trying to find extra gamma rays that might come from dark matter. So far, no dice. So, like, burly dudes tend to be bad guys? I guess not knowing if citizens are gonna attack me or not. It's a bit stressful. Cannot be opened at this time. Interesting. I'm impressed at how, like, this is almost like a borderline open world stealth game.
Yeah, hey man, the University of Saskatchewan wants to hear about gamma rays and dark matter. I'm their girl. I'll tell them all about that.
Do you agree
that
gamma rays are photons with attitude?
Gamma rays are photons with attitude. I like that description of them.
If I'm out of sleep darts, am I just hosed?
Anyone there?
I think I just have to run from him if I don't have the drop on him, unfortunately. It tells you it's a hostile area when you enter.
God, pay attention.
Where is that on the loading screen? Where does it display that this name is lame? Just so I know for
the
future.
Yeah, you might as well just kill him. You know, it'd be a really easy way to get through these guys. Murdering them, assassinating them. Check you over. And there's an inspection. As your fucking job description says you should do.
Hey. I can't believe he didn't respond to me choking out his partner right next to him.
I mean, his partner does that all the time.
Have to get good. When we say get good though, like, is there anything you can do other than run to continue playing non-lethally? Hey dude, how you doing?
I won't ask about the mask. I wouldn't want my face seen either pulling a stunt like that.
Damn straight.
You know what? I'll return the favor.
Making lunchables?
Yes. That's my business. Well, it was.
No, I'm not.
But now I'm reduced to
I'm not eating lunchables. Here and
there is the well, sure, you might not be able to see. You need anything, I can see clearly that it's lunchables.
Maybe someday the plague will blow over and everything will go back to normal. But until then, it's scavenging for me.
Whenever I drink, I get hungry.
Want to look at some of the things I found?
Drunks.
Good prices,
ooh. Scavenger shop.
Ooh, that guy ugly. Shit.
A lot of the characters in this game are pretty ugly. Ooh, blueprints. That's cool. Interesting. Yeah, I guess I'll get those.
Yeah, I'm making pizza lunchables. Huh? I have a whole routine.
Get anything else in your house, bud?
No, it's nice.
Whoa, what the hell's going on up here, dude? You didn't tell me about all the dead folks on the floor above you.
I mean, you didn't ask.
Bone charms provide small supernatural benefits. Locate them by listening to the song they emit. Well, you can activate up to 3 bone charms at once in the bone charms section of the journal. Oh, what did they do? Are they unique effects? Oh, that's cool. They're like little perks.
Excited? Oh,
I'm so excited. I didn't know what they
Add
were going to be.
Flavor.
They're not consumable. They're always on. Oh, that's the best. It's like the they're like the passive vigors in
Yeah, I don't know what a passive vigor is.
Remember in Bioshock Infinite, you could get the little drinks, and some of them are passives that give you boosts.
Oh, like you can make them a bowl?
Well, they were passive. You didn't have to turn them on. They were just always on.
Oh!
Sailor's Blessing. Carving itself as a practice from long back, passed from father to son, old man salt to greenhorn, still getting the sea legs beneath them. The old times, men cut into the tusks of ice seals and into the arm-long fangs of
ice
bears.
Ice seals?
Arm-long fangs of bears? Man, this world is getting cooler as it goes. I like how they drip-feed the fantasy stuff to you,
dude,
right?
Remember the armored bears in the like Golden Compass trilogy?
Mm-hmm. Did you know there's a new trilogy?
There's a new one?
Yeah, it's going to be coming out in October.
What's his nuts?
Yeah,
Philip Pullman.
Yeah, he announced it. First book comes out.
Is he going to like literally murder God again? Because that was awesome.
I don't know. I guess we'll see.
I really liked the Golden Compass, the His Dark Materials trilogy.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Okay.
I remember as a kid being like, I don't know what a daemon is, but I'm just gonna roll with it.
Sometimes I feel like blinking places that are just really trivial to walk to because it feels so cool to do. Hey, we made it past the wall of light. Through shenanigans.
A religion is bad if you're worshiping an asshole authority. Fuck that asshole. My only complaint about that is that the last, like, 50 pages, it's like the Lord of the Rings. The last 50 pages are not necessary.
No.
The book should end.
Well, Lord of the Rings, the last several hundred pages aren't necessary. We really don't need to know about Sharky and the Scouring of the Shire.
No, no, stupid guy.
How'd you call it, like, the subtitle or something? The subtitle knife.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. John Clavering Boulevard has been designated a restricted travel area. Any citizens are liable to search or...
But yeah, I remember, like, at the discretion teenage, you know, high school slash late middle school age Andrea... Seeing the guy be like, yo man, when you die, my atoms are gonna find your atoms and it's gonna be the shit. And I was like, whoa. Just blew my
That's
little
basically what 13 happens,
year though. Old mind. Yeah, there's no reason for there to be a subtle. It's not
there.
There
are lots of words in English. Which is generally a problem. I really like working behind people to...
This guy's like, oh man, we have this like super amazing ointment for your finger that just got cut off, and like it's super rare, and it's like Neosporin.
Right. Nice. Ooh, Tivian ore. That's worth less money than I was hoping it would be. Need to get all the cash, because upgrades are expensive. Let's see, where are... There's a rune this way, I might be able to get to it. Let's try.
Attention,
the fishmonger's house, maybe?
The following businesses have been closed and impounded by the state due to contamination. Barrow's Barbershop and Surgery, the Duke and Dancer Ale House, Merritt's Printing Firm, Pennyworth's Tack and Saddle Emporium, and the Smoke Street Dice Hall.
It's like, okay, so it's not in this building. There's a bone charm near this building. I'm really stoked about the bone charm mechanic. Super cool. Potted whale meat.
Ah.
Delicious. That's a lot of journal entries. She's sad about her
child. Does anyone
child
know what whale
died.
Tastes like?
Nope. Imagine it's very, very fatty.
Is it like... crocodile? Is it a white meat? It's probably a white meat, right? Because it's like a fish.
So the runes down there, this is going to drive me crazy with the heart, like, I'm sure there's certain runes I can't get to right away. I'll have to get quests or new abilities or something to get to them.
Aw, oh, Lindsay's eating whale? Alright.
Unless if it's the
really
one that...
It's a dark meat? Ah. Oh. Weird.
It is a mammal.
Well, so the chicken.
Chicken's not a mammal.
No, it's not. What the fuck is a mammal? Oh, right, they have the babies
Hair.
And then they birth them.
Yeah.
Right, no, you're right. You're right.
I'm not gonna, like.
What the
give
hell
you
is
shit
a chicken? A poultry?
How no, much? But, how many Stellas have you had?
I was very liberal with the gin and the gin and fresca that I just drank.
What are you doing down here, Granny?
Lanel's best scientist. Oh, man.
Chicken is a dinosaur, that's correct.
Dude, I hated biology. I hated it. So much. I remember we had to, like, memorize the reproductive cycle of a protist, I think it's called, like a fucking mushroom. And I was just like, I don't care.
Now, does she get mad at me if I just take this?
But there you go, proof that you can be a scientist and not know shit about whatever we're talking about. Mammals. Protozoan, that's probably it.
Cool. She's super old. Because we knew she was a magician. We saw her teleport when we first went up here. Them all, measure their worth, and find them wanting.
Then, she made a different choice. You're on your way to face the High Overseer, the leader of a great cult dedicated to loathing me. What will you do, I wonder?
Oh yeah, T10? Cool.
Get out. Arnold Schwarzenegger says that. I told you the knives go on the left. They've always
gone on the left. You never What's your deal?
She told you this like 10 minutes ago. You put the knives on the left. It's not that hard.
Okay, are there ever friendly NPCs who will become hostile if you take their rune like I just did with them noticing you? I just want to make sure I understand the mechanic there, that I don't get myself killed or trigger a hostile event unnecessarily. I thought she was going to get all pissed and fight me.
Well, dude, that's part of playing the game, isn't it?
What?
Like, trying shit out and seeing if they kill you for it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just curious if that's an ongoing mechanic in the game, you know?
Like, how does
aggro work?
Keep playing the game.
Looking for something special?
Oh yeah.
Who's the dude I rescued? Bye then. You can always loot without problems. Okay, thank you. Now that, see, if the problem is that if I can always loot without problems,
okay.
I'll never know that unless if someone tells me.
Sure.
Right.
Well, you can.
I'll
know
be afraid
that
every single time.
Every single time, and then at the end.
I guess I could have looted everything instead of spending an extra 10 minutes on each encounter. Playing it extra safe. Whoa. You wake up, dude? I guess I must have unloaded
where
he was.
You were really loud. You just, like, jumped up there and were like, whoa!
Yeah. But I was already here, and I knocked these guys out. I guess they wake up eventually once you unload the area that they're in.
People tend to wake up after they're asleep. They don't sleep forever. If they sleep forever, that would be killing them, which you apparently don't want to do.
I'm a good assassin.
Yeah, maybe you should just kill him. Because you know what people stay? They stay dead. They don't stay asleep.
Because I must have been a different guard. I see some of my other guards that I knocked out earlier out here. Yeah, no worries.
Yeah, how do you pronounce that person's name? Gishamot Bag? Goshman Bag?
Gishim?
Gishim?
No worries, Gishim. Thank you for being sensitive to it.
That's like
appreciate
some Torah
that.
Shit, right? Isn't the Torah written all in like consonants with no vowels?
Yes.
In like the real Hebrew?
Ancient Hebrew.
Yeah.
Sure. The vowels are assumed. silly person, Andrew. I love you. If you're not sure about whether a hint is kosher, you can discuss it with the other people in chat and !hide. If you type hide before your message, everyone in chat can see it, but I cannot see it. So you can be like, hey, he asked this question. Do you think it's okay if I say this? And generally, I'll trust the consensus of chat. So you always feel safe to just say whatever's on your mind and hide.
Yep.
And then if you're not sure if something's okay to share, put it in there. And then mods are empowered to clear the chat, too, in case something gets through.
And, you know, we've all been cleared.
Yeah, everybody does it. I've done
it
before.
Dude, there have been times where, like, I want to say something, and he just pushes the mute button.
Yeah, you know.
Because he's like, no.
I mean, Andrew has talked about the end of, like, 6 different books, movies, and games today, so.
I don't think you can ever read the high chat. Or no, you can if you look. You probably can.
I blog
but he doesn't.
I don't really read it though.
I can guarantee you.
I keep a login just in case there's any moderation issues.
He's an honest bro.
All right, so if there's just a little, like, lightning bolt tick around their head like that, that means that they're suspicious, but they didn't actually see me. What's the they saw me indicator? Oh, God. Can you stop walking? Thank you for stopping to walk.
Dude, Arrival was awesome. If you all haven't seen that movie, you should get right on that. I will not spoil it. It's a smart movie.
Uh-oh.
Oh man, they saw you!
They did.
They saw you, like, not kill the fuck out of that guy. Ah, oh, G-I-G.
G works.
But yeah, no, man, that's how, like, you know, ancient Hebrew is written. They just assume that you'll figure out what vowels they
Yeah, Arrival is the kind of story you want to know nothing about. I agree.
Oh, it's like, what's that movie?
Cabin in the Woods.
Yes, yeah,
so, you know. Versus Evil.
Yeah. You just don't want to know anything about those movies. Just watch them. Just know that they are good and worth your time.
Oh. Okay, let's see.
Oh, I watched, The Prestige? No.
Yeah,
Prestige. Yeah, The Prestige.
Well, be careful.
The other day. Anyway, and there is this big spoiler, and he knew it, but I was completely virgin. I had no idea what the spoiler was. And it was a really good movie.
I'm glad you liked it.
I recommend The Prestige.
Andrea is an interesting person. Like, she takes a while to process... No, I'm saying... You take a while to process things. When I showed you The Prestige, you didn't seem that thrilled.
Well, I really liked it.
I know, but you have to... You're not at the end of the movie like, oh man, that movie was rad. You're just... It'll be like 3 weeks later, you're like, I really like that movie. I'm like,
yeah.
Oh, good. I thought it kind of disappointed you. I'm glad that you enjoyed it.
Hooray. No, it was a good movie. I imagine that Christian Bale had a great time doing his character.
Yeah.
And that's all I'll say about that. Also, it's got, like, magic. I like magic, and it's, like, Victorian kind of times. I'm down with that. It's got Scarlett Johansson. She's hot. I like her.
Oh, come on, game. I don't know how often that's going to happen before...
You could just
After that happens a certain number of times, I'm going to just start killing them, I think. When I press the, like, knock them out button, and it doesn't work... Because it wants me to guard instead.
Do stabby McStabberson.
Here we go.
Oh, yeah, I didn't see Prometheus. I heard
You're not missing out. It's not bad, it's just not great.
Although Prometheus is something that I think I'd read the Wikipedia summary about. If that means anything. God's eyes. It's like, I read the Wikipedia summary of Requiem for a Dream. I'm never gonna watch Requiem for a Dream. I've heard that it's terrible and makes you sad, and I don't like being sad. But I know what the plot is. Oh, it's also like I read the plot of, what's the damn movie that's stupid? 50 Shades of Grey. Because I was like, you know, a lot of people have watched this movie. I should at least know what the fuck the plot of this movie was.
Yeah, I feel like there's a lot of movies, like, when I went and saw the Star Wars prequels when I was a kid when they first came out,
Oh, dead body's not gonna touch that. Oh, this weird worms thing? Yeah, let me just rub it all over me.
I didn't have an issue with the Phantom Menace when I saw it in theaters. I was excited to just have Star Wars, but after I let it process for a few days, I was like, was that good? There we go.
I love when they compare the beginning of A New Hope to... It's not Empire Strikes Back.
Attack of the Clones?
No. The first one.
Phantom Menace?
Phantom Menace, yeah. So right at the beginning of, like, New Hope, you have some cool battle sequence, probably, but at the beginning of Phantom Menace, you have this, like, weird political discussion about trade and something boring.
Yeah.
And it's stupid.
It's awful. Trade, taxation, disputes... It's like, where's the Jedi? I mean, you can have a movie that's about that, but this... Well, no, that's a problem.
Yeah.
There's too many lightsabers.
Too many lightsabers. Right. Everyone's a Jedi. Yeah. Although I do like when Yoda's battling Count Dooku.
2,000 coins. Yeah, she's talking about Red Letter Media. The offenses of this man are high crimes under the strictures of the High Overseer.
Yeah, that review is awesome. I love when they're also like, you know, describe this character without saying the actor or what they look like.
What their costume is. And they're
like, you know, Han Solo is like, man, he's a scoundrel with a heart of gold. And then they're like, okay, Queen Amidala. And they're like, Natalie Portman.
Hair.
Look She's at got that. That weird hair. That's that? A lot of rats.
Yeah.
That was a really good review. Pointed out a lot of interesting things.
Okay, so there's stuff in there that looks interesting, but I don't want to deal with the rat.
That's
king.
A good point, Hugo Poe. It could have been interesting.
Yeah, there, like people have done the "what if the prequels were good," like re-exploring the same basic plot but just changing the POV.
So, like, just recently, he had never seen Aaron Brockovich, and so we watched Aaron Brockovich. And like, you think about it on, you know, face level or whatever, that should be a boring ass movie.
It was well presented. I was taking a second to figure out where you were going with that, but I understand.
It should be
I'm on board.
Really boring movie about some like technical law dispute. Blah blah. Real estate.
I don't actually care about anything in that room, and the rats are not worth
it. They made it interesting.
If I let the rats out, they'll eat the sleeping people that I left behind, and I don't want that to happen because I'm a nice assassin who doesn't kill anybody.
They're giving you all these beautiful, creative ways to kill people, and you're just like spitting in their face.
Yeah, no, you can make a movie about politics and trade. I think it's the issue is more that it's not Star Wars. Like, I'd love to watch a movie that's like Law and Order, but I wouldn't want to watch an Indiana Jones movie that's like Law and Order, you know? What did he knock over, did you see?
Oh, just your games on the shelf there. Okay. You know, his typical.
Yeah, 12 Angry Men is one of my favorite movies ever.
Right? That should be boring as hell. Super that movie good. Was awesome.
I like that there are female guards in this game. And this game has passed the Bechdel test. Hey, thanks for the follow, Trey. Okay, I can dismiss a power once I start charging it. That's good to know. Oh, she's actually following me for once.
Who, the old lady?
No, the guard. The guards usually don't follow you when they hear you.
I don't know, they think they heard something. No, why would you come?
I know you're somewhere around here.
No, I'm not.
I'm not making any noise, guys.
I'm nowhere.
Okay, where are you?
Nowhere.
Yeah, it's nice.
Oh, someone's not feeling well. Hello?
No shit.
Come out.
He's here.
Shit.
Kill him! Kill him, kill him, kill him, kill him, kill him!
Oh, I missed. What's the tolerance for killing people in this game? Well, I don't need to not kill anyone, but I would like to get the less chaotic ending. Like, what are the thresholds for low chaos? I know that's a fun thing to maybe find out on your own, but I'm okay to just kind of generally have an idea.
You also know, can he kill at least one person?
Is it between... Yeah, is it one? Is it between... Is it less than five? Is it a percentage?
This is an okay question to answer in terms of a number.
Yes, thank you.
Does that sound correct?
Yes, thank you. Man, I really dig this power. A good use of my runes to help me find my stuff later.
It's complicated.
It's complicated.
Well, shit, you can't just get a simple number.
Is it one? It's not strict, okay.
There,
so occasionally if I get
guy.
Aggroed, I'm not going to kill them right now. Maybe if I aggro them again. There's no reason to kill them right now.
It's less strict than Undertale.
Okay, thank you. Rats that carry the plague. Complicated.
Can he kill this one guy if he aggroes him again? I mean, that's
so,
really the question at hand.
That was the wind. The sound of a sword banging off a wall. The wind. Now, when I heard that loud, like, orchestra hit sound, like the discordant string noise, did that mean detected as far as the ghost mode is concerned? Or does that just mean they heard something and I should be wary?
That's nice.
Again? Seriously? Did you see that?
What? No.
I wasn't right behind her.
Yep.
It was really frustrating.
And she died?
No, I was right behind her and I didn't get... That's alerted.
Just kill the guys. Just kill these guys. It's gonna be fun.
Outsider's eyes. It's an interesting oath. Let's see if she patrols back into the same room here. I guess everything's all right. Oh, I wasn't sneaking. Oh, it's easy for me to forget. Guess it's the way he holds his weapon, right? Okay. Try to be more careful about that. Is that why I wasn't able to take her down last time?
Again? No. Can't someone help me?
Just kill her.
I don't know why she looked at me that time.
I love you, Ben. Yes, I do. Maybe wind or something. He's so happy.
The wind. Come on. After I take care of these two, I'm gonna switch over to Jackbox. Let's see if I can find a better place to hide. Maybe this folding screen will work. I don't know if she's gonna come all the way back in the corner. She has a key on her. Yeah, that works, defense. Just a rough percentage would be helpful. Just like in the interest of the stream, like if I were playing it off stream, I'd probably try to not kill anyone ever, but I also don't want to spend four times as long on the game reloading saves whenever I do make a mild mistake. You know? There we go. Okay, so that's not too bad. Thank you. Thank you for asking as well. Oh, I don't have to hold the X button the whole time I'm carrying them. That's good to know as well. Yeah, that's very reasonable. Let me see if I can go take out the big guy. And when Andrea gets back, I'll start up Jackbox.
Well, I'm back.
I'm taking out the big guy and I'll start it up. Cool. Thank you. I appreciate it. I know it detracts a teensy bit from the blind element of the blind playthrough, but... There we go. It's interesting that there's multiple copies of the different keys. There's not just one way to get them.
Hey! Enjoy your shot, Sailor Dan.
There's multiple different ways to get the key. You don't have to kill the maid. You don't have to go to this certain section of the level. That's really well designed. Yeah. Cool. I'll be back in a few minutes. I'm going to go feed our cats so that they calm down, and Andrea will get y'all started with some Jackbox.
And start it up for me, right?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
I'm going to hook everybody up with understanding what's coming up on the schedule next week. One second.